Hey, this is Watsky from the Hashtag No Offense Show.
And I'm the Duchess, and you're listening to The Hood Diner with your favorite casual DJ.
Hey, white girl, it's the homie Casual and DJ Century.
Oh, you look, yummy.
Only on the Inner Circle Podcast Network.
Order up, bitch.
Bleep stay burning.
I got a question for you guys. You got your mic with you?
Yes, sir.
If you could have sex with one fucking celebrity, who would it be?
Fuck.
Yeah, that.
A. Marie.
Who's that?
Remember the singer from back in the day?
Yeah, just one thing.
Yeah, one thing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, really?
I
think A. Marie.
Where's she been at?
I don't know. I don't know. I have no clue. I think she's waiting on me.
There you go.
She's got to be waiting on me.
What about you, Doug?
How would you shoot your shot with her? Because you couldn't come off on some old fucking fuckboy shit. You know what I'm saying? Not saying that's of your character. I'm just saying.
My man, like, just, that was a misdirected
shot. No. Because I don't even know you like that. You
friendly fire. Backhanded compliments and shit.
No. I never seen homie at work. So I don't know what, you know. He's a rapper, so he has a good mouthpiece. I don't know how he is with the ladies.
What?
Just scenarios. You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying, you're not going to fucking be like, hey, what's your sign type shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, nothing like that. I mean, it'll probably just be
on some cool shit, right?
Like, yeah, it'll probably just be on some cool shit, just like a vibe. Like, I'm not going to, like,
send somebody, you know, like a courier or
yeah,
shit?
Yeah, nothing like that. Like, I wouldn't, like, I'd pull up on her, like, introduce myself and whatnot, and then it had to be like a long game. You know what I'm saying? Like,
it had to be in person, though, too, right?
Yeah.
Like, in person, right? Like,
oh, yeah, nothing online.
She's at the same function. I'm about to holler. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it would have to be something like that. Introduce myself, exchange information, and then kind of go from there, like, the long game. I'm not that type that could just, you know,
what's up, girl?
In an hour, you know what I'm saying? Make it happen.
What about you? Who would it be?
You can't answer that question because you're married or what?
I'm going to answer it. I got to answer it. I thought of the question. You don't think I got to answer?
I'm just trying to think offhand because, like, probably Nicki real quick.
Nicki Minaj?
Yeah, because she's married and shit.
Do it right now. She's trying to start
a
family.
She's trying to start a family.
Right?
She's trying to start
a family, bro. Right. That's one of the topics. Don't go
she
too far.
She just retired.
That's one of the topics. Don't we'll get there. Oh, okay, we're going into music. Yeah. So, Nicki Minaj, huh?
Nah, you know what? Real talk, like, I'd probably fuck me a porn star, dog. Oh, shit.
You a Mia Khalifa kind of guy?
No, like a Bella Danger.
Okay, I got you.
Yeah. Did you see that video where she came out saying she only made like 12
7
G's,
grand or something?
Was
it 12?
I thought she said 12. Stupid. Yeah.
It was something
weird. She only made 12 G's.
We talked about that on a previous podcast. If I was a young female that had a banging body, I'd be a cam girl. Day one. What's up? Oh, yeah.
I just want to make sure.
My other computer will scroll with the recording, but for a reason, this one doesn't.
It's old.
But no, it's a brand new Live 10.
I know that, but it's probably the computer can only handle so much shit.
Well,
or you probably have to go into the settings.
Yeah.
And change it to where it like stays live, you know what I'm saying? But I bet you that takes a lot of fucking memory
RAM.
Right there in itself, yeah. Y'all, RAM. That's what you try to do, right? I got an answer, dog. My answer would be
J-Lo.
J-Lo,
yeah. She's a bad 50-year-old.
I mean, dog, think about the experience
she's got. I let
her fart
in my face, bro.
I think about the experience J-Lo has. Like, not only was she a fly girl, you know what I'm saying? So she was probably, you know, I mean, just the movements, just the fucking...
Can I retract my statement?
Probably ride that shit for you, you know what I'm saying?
Like, yeah. Rosie Perez, because I just seen a picture of her.
You want a fly girl, too?
Because I just seen a picture of her the other day. She's like 50-some years old and still banging, bro.
Yeah.
What's that?
I love that fucking...
You seen that movie where she was with John Leguizamo?
Yeah.
Oh, stupid, Billy. But the sex scene in that one was... Woo.
White men can't jump.
Yeah, dude. You're so stupid, Billy. Like, I'm talking like she jumped off it and started... Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, in the movie, I was like, okay. And then John Leguizamo couldn't do it, man. He couldn't handle it. Couldn't get it up.
That's whack.
He was stressing. But dude, J-Lo, because fucking, I mean, yeah, dog, like the experience, bro, you know what I'm saying? You know Puff, he probably taught her some shit,
man.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
order up. This is a certified hood classic.
You are now tuned into the Hood Diner Podcast with your hosts, DJ Sentry and the homie Casual.
Bro, that's way too much work, bro. I just want to go in there and rocket that shit out.
I bet if you Google sci-fi sex, it's there already.
What's up? This is DJ Sentry.
And I am the homie Casual.
You're listening to the Hood Diner Podcast.
Yeah, baby. This is episode 62.
And deuce.
And today, in the building, we got Mr. Tommy Will.
Hey, yay.
What's going down, bro?
What's happening, fellas? How y'all doing?
I've been trying to get you in here for a minute, but this man has been very, very busy, and I understand, and that's okay. That's okay.
Things always happen to where
I'm thankful that you came in today because you got a lot of shit going down right now. So it's a really good time to have you here so we can talk about it. You know what I'm saying?
That's what I was going to say is things usually happen that way. When we get people in here, it always lines up with the project that they're doing.
Right.
So it's great timing.
No, it is. Absolutely.
I think it's the universe speaking. You know what I'm saying?
That's been happening a lot lately.
You know what I'm saying? Some cross promotion. Everybody, like, you know, we all help each other grow, man.
I think one thing that we've common thread that we've had in the podcast is like Tucson uplifting Tucson.
Yeah! Yes, sir. Absolutely.
That needs to happen for us to have a scene here.
Oh yeah, definitely. You got to grow from the ground up. You got to get your roots.
As he hits the joint,
right? Dude, that shit was funny, dude. He set that up so good. He's like, I was going to press record until I got high.
Well, last week.
Yeah, dude, because remember I told you how we did like 20 minutes, man, where like it was some uncut shit.
Right.
But dude, we got to do some Michael Jackson. We got to do some other shit that wasn't even on the docket. wasn't even going to be spoken of. But check this out, dog. Before we go any further, we got to give some sponsorship recognition and shit. Let's get these bills out the way, dog. Got to give a shout out to Dude Wipes.
Is that a little ringtone? Right
oh,
there?
Fuck. Yeah, that's a beep, dollar. Boop, that's a beep. Dollar. That's a dollar in the fucking bin, bro. My bad.
First sponsor is Dude Wipes. Yeah. Shout out to Dude Wipes. Hashtag no mud butt movement.
Yeah, you can go to Twitter. You can see DJ Century Chonies on the ground. He took a picture. You know, he had the Dude Wipe right there and shit. So
I would have taken one on the Flix bus, but that was just way too much work and way too many germs.
Ugh.
Like, if your fucking balls or your ass touch that public restroom, you might as well have AIDS.
That's where the Dude Wipe would have came in handy, though, right there, too.
Right.
That's why you got to roll with fucking antibacterials, too.
I hear that, but I'm not going to... Bro, that's way too much work, bro. I just want to go in there, rocket that shit out, a couple Dude Wipes, wash the hands, and then you're back to business, dog.
It's a rocket.
No. I don't even go to a gas station if it ain't got...
Bro,
that
it wasn't a matter of if it was going to happen,
the
dog.
No,
like, it was
gaskets.
Either shit in my pants or go to that fucking hellhole. That death trap, bro. But
that's a tough situation.
Yo, but as an artist, if you had a situation where budget allowed you to go perform in another state, but you had to take a bus that was a Flick bus because that's what your budget allowed, would you do that to go perform?
Absolutely.
With a heartbeat, right?
Without a doubt, yeah.
So you're making, say you make $300 on the thing, your room's going to cost you $125, and the bus ride's going to cost you $50. That's a no-brainer, right?
It's a no-brainer. Like, it's a no-brainer.
So that's how I felt with the vacation. Like, I was just going to make it happen, you know what I'm saying? Like, it literally cost me $125 for 3 days.
I feel that, yeah.
And that was with my ticket, you know what I'm saying? So just make it happen, you know?
And this has to do with Dude Wipes. Why?
Because I wipe my ass on the Flix bus. They come through in the clutch every time.
Go to dudeproducts.com and use code HOOD and get 15%
off
your entire order. Dudeproducts.com.
Next sponsor is Official Clothing.
Official Clothing. That's OHFISHL.com. Use code HOOD. Get 25% off your whole order. Get free shipping over $50. And yeah, man. Rest assured, if you get a fucking package from us, it was hand-delivered and put together by either me or Mr. DJ Century. You know what I'm saying? So
with love.
You order from Official, you are basically supporting the fucking diner at the same time. You know what I'm saying? So shout out to everybody.
One hand washes the other.
Shout out to everybody that's going to official.com. Use code HOOD. Get 25% off your order. Mr. Tommy Will is no stranger to Official Clothing, man. He's been fucking with me since back in the day, I first started. You know what I'm saying? I got some good fucking... actually, shout out to Aperture. She took a dope-ass photo shoot with Tommy Will rocking some Official sweaters and shit.
Yeah.
And then who else was with you? Your boy.
The homie Billy. Billy Bejarano.
There you go. Yeah, he was on some dope one. You guys were rocking some Official gear back then and shit.
The big
too,
homie,
so.
Man.
So shout out to you. Thank you for fucking doing that shit. My fucking throat is cashed right now.
You know the thing right there?
Where is it? Oh, yes. Dude, it's been a minute since I've mentioned motherfucking
Biotene. That's like Visine for the throat.
Oh, I heard
That's what fucking, that's what Shayna called it.
Have beautiful. You taken any like singing classes?
No.
You want to try something?
You think not something like that would help
yes,
you?
I would love to. Absolutely.
Biotin.
It's definitely one of the things
on my list. And shit.
Yeah, I think it's just the breathing more so for live performances, definitely. But for catching the melody, I mean, a lot of my new music is more harmonic. It's very influenced by a couple of different artists that I'm sure we'll talk about further on down. But yeah, so I mean, that type of thing would help. And there's somebody that I'm working with right now, you know, that's definitely been helping out with that as well, just kind of like watching and stuff. But I'm sure that's another thing we'll get into
Definitely will. Oh, and also, I'm just going to announce it now, dog, because hopefully by the next podcast, we'll be fucking smoking on these shit. Oh, shit, I give away too much already, y'all.
Yep. Disqualified.
Cat is out of the bag.
I'm going to tell Tommy Will what it is, but I'm going to cut it all out. Or I'm just going to, like, all the fucking shit out of it. But basically, dog, I found out the other day, I signed up, or I hit these fools up and said, hey, dog, you know, we want to represent the fucking brand and shit. So we got, we're getting a little sponsorship with this company called.
A few moments later.
Hey, pass me some of them peanut butters.
Okay, they're right there. They're behind us.
You're wild for that. Two is the limit, bro.
I've been off this sugar shit for so long. I'm so deprived right now. I'm in hog heaven right now, dog.
Also,
I'm trying to get burly, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm gonna look like Arnold someday, you know?
Also, we gotta give a shout out to Podcoin. You listen to a lot of podcasts, bro?
Which one?
You listen to podcasts?
Oh, yeah, yeah, no, I do.
What do you usually use to listen to podcasts?
Spotify.
Spotify?
Yeah.
I like Spotify.
I'm definitely a Spotify guy.
Because you wanna know what I really love about Spotify? Is Spotify has a 1.25. On the listening fucking speeds.
Oh yeah.
Apple goes in increments of 5, so it's like 0.5 to 1, 1.5. 1.5 is just too fast, bro. But 1.25, dog, it helps me get through podcasts faster and it doesn't change up the tones too much. Like when it's 1.5, it's kind of fast, dog.
Right, I can do it,
I can handle it, but I like the 1.25. So I listen to a lot of people's podcasts on Spotify.
You know that you can key lock the vocals and raise the tempo if you want.
Yeah, but I don't need to do that.
Well, I'm just saying.
I don't need to do that. Yeah, I mean, it's fine. It's not that I want to hear us at that. I'm talking about listening to other podcasts and shit, you know what I'm saying?
But if you're at
90, but I have listened to us at like 1.5, and that shit's hilarious. Yeah! Because my ass be talking all fast, and you'll be saying some shit, and it sounds all fucking Alvin and the Chipmunk style. Dude, it sounds fucking hilarious, bro. But anyways, man, so the thing that we've been pushing lately is called Podcoin, bro. Podcoin is an app where you can listen to all these podcasts, but while you're listening, you're stacking coins. And like when you get to a certain amount of coins, you can trade them in for like a gift card for Amazon, Starbucks, fucking different fucking stores. You can get gift cards. You know what I'm saying? So if you listen to a lot of podcasts, dog, you might as well fucking make something for listening to all these podcasts.
That's awesome.
That's the only thing I am recommending to Podcoin. Podcoin doesn't have that option just yet where you can change the speed and shit like that. Once they get that shit popping, bro, it's going to be on, bro. But anyways, I've been listening to my shit on Podcoin, bro, because, you know, like I said, we've been stacking these coins. I already got to the point to where I made a $5 gift card and shit like that.
Okay.
But you can also use them for, like, charities, dog. If you don't want to buy something for yourself, you can donate them to a charity and shit. Like, they have a bunch of different ones you can choose from, ones, different shit like that. You know what I'm saying? So you can go to podcoin.com, sign up, and if you use the code HOOD at the sign up, you'll get 300 bonus coins from the jump. Get you a little fucking starter kit right there just to stack some coins, you know what I'm saying? I think one of the homies was doing the math and shit. Dude, he said like around 10 hours worth of Podcoin listening. He said he got like a fucking $5 card and shit. That's not that bad, dog.
That's not bad at all.
If you're going to be listening, if that's like two a day, a couple hours a day and shit like that, psh, that ain't shit. And then you got to think about people that live like in LA, bro. Like they're driving like a lot, man. So fucking stack up some shit while you're fucking, some money while you're driving and shit. Get you a little coins and shit, you know what I'm saying? This way your coffee or your fucking whatever at Starbucks comes out of this. Now you got money for gas or whatever straight the fuck, up. You know what I'm saying?
Put your headphones in at night.
Trying to sell it way too hard,
huh? While you sleep.
Come on, I'm trying to sell that shit way too hard.
I literally lost my fucking water.
Damn.
My leg, Charlie Murphy.
What am I doing with my leg?
Dude, where's my water? Okay. So,
where's my water?
We're going to get into some news here. I don't really got too much news going on, but.
News.
football's back. That's okay, what I give a
we're
fuck
gonna get,
about.
We're going to get to sports. We're going to get to sports and shit. As far as, like, world news shit, obviously you got the Hurricane Dorian going on and shit. I was already... I'm going to do it, dog. And, like, honestly, like, I don't think it's funny, but I kind of think it's funny because, you know, the homie Just Dorian and shit like that.
Yes.
I already thought of, like, this little graphic of the fucking thing turning with his little logo dude spinning. I'm going to send it to him, dog. It's going to be up to him if he wants to do something with
it. That's so insensitive.
You think so? Really? Is it bad?
It's
That's not
bad.
Good. It's not funny. I mean, you were the one that sent me the fucking, the cathedral with the fucking Daenerys' fucking
Stop
dragons.
It. Stop it. You're fucking
what was
evil, bro.
The Notre Dame?
You're evil.
With the fucking Viserion and the other dragon flying over it and
I'm
shit.
I'm over
dude.
Y'all, bro.
Dude.
I'm over this shit.
This motherfucker. But I'm telling you.
Man, I'm Catholic.
You're desensitized.
On some serious
shit. For real.
Shit.
Hey, no, I've seen some shit.
No.
I've seen some shit, okay? So...
I'm not even being a fucker. I'm not even playing around. That's some serious shit. It's sad to see that shit. The shit that I saw a bunch of dogs that were left behind. I got all fucking sad at that shit. You know what I'm saying? But there's like some lady that's out there that she says she rescued like, I want to say like 9,000 dogs.
That's wild.
She rescued. But this is what she does though.
Yeah.
This is what she does. Like, this is her
she's
business.
Like,
so, like, but that's how many she's accumulated in, like, the past week.
Right.
Since the shit's, or the past, like, I guess, couple days since the shit's been going on. My lady kind of told me a little bit about it. I didn't get the whole fucking.
That's wild.
I didn't get the whole fucking shit 100%. But this lady, that's what this lady does, is she helps dogs find shelters and shit like that. She been out there fucking swooping up dogs and shit. Like, there's, you know, I mean, dude, hey. Thank God for people like that, you know what I'm saying? Out there fucking helping out and doing shit, you know what I'm saying? Obviously, people have to fucking think about people first, you know what I'm saying? But like, when you see that shit, it's kind of sad. So it's like,
it's very sad, but then
again, there's a lot of fucked up shit too with all that water and shit, dog. And you see fucking alligators and shit, like, oh, like, that's not good. That's not good, man. I've seen a lot of videos where people are posting it from like the second story of the houses and shit like that. And the water's
it's all the way
up there. That's fucking crazy, bro. Like, that would be sad as fuck just to see your shit floating around like that, man. So, man, bless the people that are fucking getting through it. You know what I'm saying? However they're doing it out there, man.
It's sad, water becomes toxic too.
You know what I'm saying?
It's soaking everything up.
All that shit. It's like the cars from Katrina and shit.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
All the rust and all that. These bacterias and all that, bro. I wouldn't.
Some sad shit, man. So yeah, I might just cut that whole fucking Just Dorian shit.
Not even gonna fucking. It's gonna hit the cutting room floor.
It's gonna. Maybe it'll go at the very, very end. You know what I'm saying? Like the people that really paid attention at the very end.
A little jab at the
end. I mean, you know what I'm saying? I didn't mean no fucking bad bite.
Right. None at all. But quick question: has there ever been a good movie about a hurricane?
Deep Sea, right? Perfect storm.
Would you consider that just a hurricane, though?
I mean, it's
like the fucking like a storm, though. It's not really a hurricane, right? Or yeah, maybe it is a hurricane.
I mean, if it's a typhoon, I don't know.
I can't say nothing.
Yeah, typhoon. I don't think there has been, man. I don't think there has been a fucking hurricane movie. There probably is. I would have to ask the homies from fucking Failing Hollywood. We got these new fucking podcasts as part of our network. They're called Failing Hollywood. These dudes, they all work in Hollywood.
Got you.
They work like behind the scenes type shit. One of the dudes that's in our podcast, his brother, he's the main dude from this other podcast and shit. And he's like a props master and shit, dog.
Oh, okay.
He produced swimming pools.
Word.
For Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's a cool dude, man. And he was worked on a lot of cool movies. He just got done working on Glow. That show about the wrestlers on Netflix.
Okay, yeah,
that's what I'm
you.
Talking about.
I got you.
You ever watched it?
I have not.
Dude, it's funny.
I'm not big on Netflix, man.
Oh,
you
really?
What?
Not big on like anything like that, really.
Okay.
If I watch anything, I watch Hulu.
Hulu?
Hulu.
Yeah,
Hulu
okay.
Got sports now.
You got Amazon Prime?
I do have it, and I never use it. I just use it when I buy shit.
Watch The Boys.
Watch The Way?
The Boys.
The Boys, dog.
It's a superhero show.
It's like superheroes gone wrong.
Gone wrong. Okay.
Gone wrong.
You know,
it's
my
dope.
Brother would love that shit, man. He's probably watched all that shit.
Shit goes hard, though, bro.
I'm at the peak.
For real, for real.
Pretty hilarious. Even the Jack Ryan, that one was pretty good. That's what the dude Jim from The Office.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Jim, as a fucking, like, a CIA agent and shit, dude.
Okay.
Doing some terrorist shit.
So he doing some real acting.
It's good, man. It's like a famous book. I think fucking Tom Cruise did a couple of those movies where he was Jack Ryan. And then, so this is like either a continuation or the prequel. I don't know.
Whatever.
But
it's
kind of funny seeing his tall ass as a fucking CIA agent and shit.
Man.
You know what I'm saying? But he's doing a good job.
That's solid.
He's,
That's solid.
He's doing a good job.
That golden face gym is going for $30 now.
Oh, the pop?
Yeah.
Okay. You should get it while before it goes up.
I'm not going to get it.
You don't like that? Yeah, well, I'm happy with my Dwight Schrute. I fuck with
you,
Dwight.
You a big Office fan?
Nah.
Me either.
I watch it.
I've seen a couple episodes, but I can't quote lines and shit.
I'm not a stan, bro. I'm not a stan of that. My brother is easy. Easy is a fucking The Office. Like, go to that one spot and do the trivia when they do the trivia for The Office and shit.
Okay.
He's big time on that.
Damn,
bro.
They do that? Where do they do that time. At? I'm going to go out there.
It's at that place on the it's on the east side. Casa Film?
Is it something like that? Oh, you're talking about the place where you can rent videos and shit?
Yeah.
Casa Video?
Casa Video, yeah, whatever it's called. It's something like that. But yeah, they do
the
trivia
one right there
nights.
On Speedway.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. They do trivia nights over there for a bunch of different shit. Okay. But anytime they do it for The Office, that man is first in line at the door.
They do Harry Potter trivia there too.
Yeah, they probably do that shit
too. They do that
shit too.
That's some good shit. We can move into music news. Doug, so yeah, like you were saying, Nicki Minaj is fucking retiring to, you know, start a family, man. So.
Did you hear that Joe Budden, Nicki Minaj radio?
Yeah, the whole situation. Yeah, yeah, I seen that.
I'm just like, she's so extra, man.
It's, I mean, how else would you expect Nicki to be?
Well, right.
You know, she wouldn't be Nicki if she didn't do that.
Right.
That Megatron's a hit.
Which
like
one?
It has that fucking heads high fucking beat, you know?
Yeah.
Like, it's... that's a fucking hit, bro.
You play
she's
that?
Gonna retire.
You play it at the clubs?
I do.
You play it?
Yeah, fuck yeah.
Is that always in the rotation?
Dude, Cobra's the fucking shit. What are you doing Saturday, dog?
I will be, I don't know what's
going
on.
Pull up to Cobra. I'll be DJing.
Okay. Yeah.
It gets cracking, bro, on Saturdays.
No, I believe it. That's why, bro, like, ever since, as with everybody, I'm guessing, man, but... I'm going through that phase of age, man. I don't like shoulder bumping motherfuckers
and all that shit, bro.
That's
why I don't go to hi-fi.
By the second time, I'm ready to just...
Yeah.
I'm not really a fighter, bro, but I'll push the fuck out of somebody.
You're right.
I'll push the fuck out of somebody.
I'll pinch the shit out of you.
And then I'll be like, hey, bro, my bad, but you just kept sitting in the fucking way, bro.
Like hey.
My bad. I'll apologize for it, but yeah.
The disrespect is real nowadays.
Super real.
It's pretty real.
Don't you think? Do you ever think it's kind of fucked up when you go out places and people kind of don't recognize you that are in your realm? I should say. I'm not saying like you go to a grocery store, but like if you go like downtown to like hip hop shows, because the amount of like, you know, the length of time that you've been in this city.
Thankfully, with me, dog, I feel like I've still continued to like even like especially with the podcast, I've got to meet like some of like the newer cats. You know what I'm saying? Some of the younger cats and shit. So I've like kind of kept like. A good foot in the door as far as it goes. But yeah, dog, there's times where I'll go to some shit and if there's not really too many dudes from my era, I'm kind of like, whatever, dog. But then I'm just like, whatever, dog. I kind of don't even think about that shit anymore, bro, because I've been in that situation where everybody wants to be your fucking homie at one minute and then the next minute, nobody really gives a fuck about you because, shit done switched up. You know what I'm saying? I always bring up the magazine. You know what I'm saying? I always bring up the 512 magazine because when that shit was popping, fucking, I got to meet every single fucking rapper, bro. Like, I was fucking friends with every rapper in town and it was dope as fuck. You know what I'm saying? But then, like, when I kind of stopped doing that, it was a different story because they didn't really want anything from me at the time.
Yeah.
They didn't need anything from me at the time. I kind of started, I started rocking with Official and shit. So, you know, not everybody was going to be buying my shit. I knew that from the jump. You know
what
I'm saying?
There's a difference.
It was always like people always have their loyalty to like that homie that has his brand. You know what I'm saying? And that's just how it goes. Like in every city, you know what I'm saying? It's like that in Phoenix. It's like that in LA. People will only rock certain shit. And it is what it is, bro. But thankfully, dog, I feel like it's always been to the point where I'm still in the with what's going on as far as the hip hop scene goes.
It's an evolution, man.
I've dipped out a lot more, but I try to still go and support like everybody that's been cool with me throughout the years. I always at least try to do that, support everybody that's been cool with me. Vinny Mendez had that fucking that opening night right there,
right,
dude. Like
that
was the first time I had set up a fucking booth in a while. But then ever since that night, I've done a couple like barber battles and a couple other little spots and shit. We got
straight
another
up.
One coming up. So it's like it's been cool, man. You know what I'm saying? Jamal's been helping me with the brand a lot more lately. So I've kind of like a lot less has been on my plate. I can kind of focus on my career, which is the graphic side of what I do. You know what I'm saying? And then still with this and shit. And then, you know, he's been helping out a lot. So that's been really cool, man. So I got to say, you know, give a shout out to him and shit.
Yeah.
I know you fuck with Jamal heavy, man.
Big
I see you guys
out,
are always fucking chilling together and
it's
shit.
Like my uncle, man. It's
you know
family.
Yeah, definitely, man. He's good. He's good peoples and shit. So yeah, as far as Nicki Minaj retiring, it is what it is. I don't really got a fucking opinion on it.
No, you don't really care.
I mean, it's cool. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. Other thing I saw in Music News Dog is they arrested the dude they said for allegedly selling the fentanyl laced drugs that killed Mac Miller, yes. Mac Miller and shit.
Yes,
dog.
I saw that.
So
bro.
Do you think that's legit? Like, or did just somebody just get put on blast, or is it like they literally backtracked it that far and they found the exact dude?
Dog,
like that's crazy, some because that's some crazy shit. Right
the
there.
Crazy thing about actually, Century, if you want to speak on this, because I might ramble.
What do you mean?
Like, if you just want to go first.
Oh,
I got
no,
a lot to say about that.
No. Yo, go ahead, dog. Go ahead.
My only input is, if you're fucking selling somebody knowingly that it's fentanyl, you deserve the worst end of the stick when it's all said and done. Like,
100%.
If you're selling somebody cocaine, it should be cocaine. If it's just, if you're selling them ecstasy, it should be ecstasy. It shouldn't be another substance because... a lot of people are falling out for that, you know?
Right. Definitely.
Nothing really more than that needs to be said on my end because it's just...
What do you think, dog? What do you think about
it's
it?
It's awful, bro. Like, I get it. You want to make money, dog. There's a way to make money, but you don't have to kill people, you know?
Right. I would think... It's... Bro, it's such a fucked up situation. So, social media is like the absolute epitome of crime watchers, bro. If you've ever seen a video go viral... Like, there was a mentally challenged young lady, and these three or four girls, like, led her outside. They said they was going to give her a ride or something like that. I don't remember the backstory. It was a couple weeks back. And then they jumped her, right?
Oh, man, really?
They jumped her. And the video came out. And pretty much all you got to say, you put it on Twitter, you say, Twitter, do your thing. Motherfuckers will find their address, the school that they go to, their shoe size,
oh yeah,
their phone number,
dude, that
all
shit
that
is real.
Shit.
That shit,
and then
real.
That's how it's like the ice cream. Motherfuckers walking into Walmart and opening up the ice cream and just looking.
Oh yeah, they found them motherfuckers quick too, right?
They get caught. Yeah. But with something like that, I feel like all it takes is for that dude to just slip up, and even just saying that you did that shit is just as bad as actually doing it.
Mm-hmm.
So it doesn't matter whether he actually did it or not. I'm positive it has to be that type of way. He slipped it to somebody who then slipped it to somebody, and that word of mouth spreads on the internet.
Oh, yeah.
They're going to find out who that dude is. Now, why it took so long, if that was the cause, you know, I would say it's because he ended up slipping up on what
something
he was talking
about. Something like
that,
yeah. Maybe he was like, dude, you know I fucked up, like to somebody he really confided in or some shit like that.
Like, how could you track that? Like, how could you track if... Like, even from right now, I sold somebody something.
Well, I mean, I guess you could be like, you know, maybe the people that are around him. Like, if you had bodyguards or drivers and shit like that, you know, they could... If yeah. those dudes came forward and said something like, yeah, you know, I would take him to this one place and he would get out the car and he would come back. Like, even little shit like that.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
to somehow backtrack, you know what I'm saying? I mean...
There's probably you know, phone logs, bro.
Yeah, that too.
When a famous person dies, it's not like a normal person. Like, me, you, whatever, we die... It's like, oh, they do an autopsy, they find the point of death, and that's it. Mm-hmm. With the famous person, it's like they need to do due diligence and figure out what the fuck happened, you know?
Yeah.
Rest in peace to Mac.
Yeah, dude, it just came up on a
rest
year.
Rest in peace to Mac.
Definitely.
And that's why it's weird, too, that came up around that time.
Bro, but you see how depressed he was in that tiny music desk, though?
Oh, my God. One of the absolute best performances of all time, bro. Ridiculous.
Yeah, it was good.
Absolutely ridiculous.
I finally went and watched that a couple weeks back. It'd been a while. I'd never seen it. And
then whenever I want to get in my feelings, I throw it on.
Yeah.
Like when I need a good cry.
That'll do it, bro.
You know what I'm saying?
That's not a good cry. That's a great cry.
That's like, fuck,
now, even speaking of that same thing, man, like Lil Peep.
Oh,
you know,
man.
Rest in peace, Lil Peep as well.
Damn, dog. Well, that shit went
and
down here.
Unfortunately, yes. It was here in town, man. And it's like, that kid's life ended in front of what was, like, one of the most popping rap venues in the town for a good minute.
Uh-huh.
You know?
Yeah.
And the legacy of that young man, like, stands right in front of it.
Right there.
And yeah. They don't even book rap. They don't even book rap no more. You know what I'm saying? But it's like, what kind of homage is that to something of that nature?
Is that why they stopped doing it? That was that why they stopped having rap shows?
I think
there?
they had a couple more, you know, after that. That wasn't the last one. And then all of a sudden it went dark, you know, and they didn't book rap after that.
I mean, you know, when it comes to like, you got to think about like the insurance side of shit. You know what I'm saying? True. Like the back end of fucking what can really go down if your fucking venue has a certain reputation.
Well, it's a difference if they're in the bus or if it's in your green room. If it happened in your green room,
I was still even.
Place would have been shut down forever.
I think even then, because anytime the buses go up there, they're still on that back lot right there. It's still kind of their property, bro. You know what I'm saying? So it's still kind of like, yeah, I can get where that would kind of
sting on the record.
It stings, you know what I'm saying? True. And it kind of sucks, man. But, you know, I mean, thank God Ava still fucking hosts decent shows, you know what I'm saying? And other places here in town, obviously, you know what I'm saying? But
absolutely.
And here we go.
Are you the Keymaster?
Laugh it up, fuzzball.
We came, we saw, we kicked it down.
This baby hits 88 miles per hour. See some serious shit.
I read this thing and I'm pretty fucking excited about it. Are you a fan of like the DC movies, the fucking Marvel movies, shit like that?
I watch them.
What's some
I
of watch them shit? Yeah. You heard about that new Joker with Joaquin Phoenix?
Yes, I have.
That trailer is ill.
It's wild.
Okay, so like apparently like it's being watched already like in Europe and shit or somewhere out there and shit like that. And it was a Venice Film Festival. It said that it received an 8 minutes long standing ovation at the end and shit like that. So that's kind of good news, you know what I'm saying? For the show or for the movie. And I can't wait till that one comes out. That one is going to be out October 4th.
It'll be better than Endgame.
Oh, God. Oh, man. Yeah, that's tough. That's tough.
Or at least it'll have a bigger response.
Yeah, it's possible. I mean, you know.
Look at what is coming after.
It is very possible. You know? And I think the difference is that's one of the reasons why I don't hate DC movies. I hate the ending fight scenes. I feel like they're just too fucking long. But I like the darkness on DC movies. You know what I'm saying? Like the Suicide Squad, I kind of liked it, dog. It was decent. The Batman movies, I've always loved the Batman movies, obviously. So, and where was my high ass going? Oh, okay. There's the Joker one right there. It's cool. It's going to be dope. I think that was going to be fucking really cool, man.
I think it's going to be crazy.
Plus, Joaquin Phoenix, he's pretty dope, man. You know what I'm saying? He gets down and shit.
They say he lost like 40 or 50 pounds?
Something like that, yeah.
He's hella skinny in that trailer.
My God.
Fucking crazy, man.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah.
So I'm excited for that. So I guess we were talking about Amazon. There's a new show out there. It's called fucking Carnival Row. I don't know if you've seen any trailers for that shit. No. It's, what's his name? What is his name from fucking Pirates of the Caribbean?
Johnny Depp.
Not Johnny Depp, the other dude.
Orlando Bloom.
There you go. It's him. And then the girl. What is her name? She was on Suicide Squad. She was the chick that was the witch. It's like Eva something. That guy, anyways, she's in there. It's a crazy ass fucking show, bro. But it's kind of like a combination of Sherlock Holmes, Harry Potter, Star Trek, Lord of the Rings, and one more. What's the other one? I think probably just those right there. It's kind of a really weird combination. It's like it's in London, but it's like there's other species of people. Like these, like the main bitch, that chick. I can't remember her fucking name. I'll insert it right here.
Cara Delevingne.
She's like a fairy. She has wings. She can fly and shit. You know what I'm saying? There's like a whole species of just like her. There's a bunch of different style species. You know what's dope? Is it show like a sex scene with one of these fucking fairies and shit like that?
You know that shit?
And when the dude was about to fucking bust his shit, they both started to fly off the bed and shit like that, dude. It's like, oh, shit. She was picking his ass up off the fucking bed. It was some crazy sci-fi shit. You would think of some sci-fi sex, it would be just like that.
Okay.
And sometimes it's so good, it took you the fuck out the
Never
bed.
Never Google sci-fi sex, but I mean...
I bet if you Google sci-fi sex, it's there already.
Okay.
But anyway, this is a really crazy show. It's out. It's pretty dope. My dad kind of liked it and shit.
I went and watched Good Boys last night.
Okay. You said that
fucking
was
fucking hilarious. It is so
I haven't seen any trailers for that.
It's a movie about a bunch of sixth graders that get into some hijinks and have to go acquire an item throughout the whole movie. But
you said
it's like,
it was like a fucking drone or something like that?
Yeah, but... Like, it's just fucking hilarious, bro.
Is it funny?
Yeah.
Is it like rated R?
Yeah.
It's rated R.
Yeah.
Okay.
I have a nephew that age. That's why it kind of resonates with me.
Okay.
So I can, literally that age, so I can see him running around doing that stupid shit.
Doing
you know?
His shit. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's a recommend right there.
Okay. And then the other thing I was going to tell you, first of all, we got to pause and give a shout out to fucking Kevin Hart, man, for having, I mean, I don't want to say a shout out. We got to show him some love, I guess. It would
absolutely
be the right term.
Yeah.
You know
show
what
that
saying?
Man some love. Got man. Fuck,
got into he got into a bad accident and shit like that. I'm totally going to cut that shit out. We're going to give him a shout out. That is the wrong terminology.
You
I apologize, dumbass. Tommy Will.
You fixed it, man, bro.
That is not the right terminology right there. You know
your
what
heart's
saying?
In a good place.
Exactly. Exactly. You know what I'm saying? We got to give a heartfelt shout out, some love to Kevin Hart, man. Hopefully he gets better soon and shit.
That's up, man. Yeah.
Because that's some fucked up shit. And I saw the picture of the car, bro. It looks fucking horrible. Like the whole top is missing and shit. I think it's missing or it got concaved in and
what
shit.
What kind
like
of car
that.
Was he driving in?
It's like a really nice, like old school Lincoln, I think it was.
Oh, yeah.
It was like, it was a longer car and shit. You know what I'm saying? It was like a nice old school, I think it was. But if, man, fuck, that sucked. I saw the picture. It was bad. We were just talking about this the other day, dog. Multiple different series, like on fucking Netflix from now on, they're going to start releasing them a week at a time.
You what?
Instead of just dropping whole fucking series at once. You know what I'm saying? Remember how we were talking about that? Like, there's people who, like, will fucking just burn through the shit, and then you're, like, left fucking hanging. Man. Like, son of a bitch. They're switching to, like, some HBO-style shit where it's coming to come out every week and shit. So you keep people in suspense. You keep that buzz building. It's kind of smarter if you really think about it. You know
so it justifies your subscription.
I guess, yeah, there you go. There you go. Yeah, that's a good word on it right there. Yeah. Justify the fucking
subscription.
You're going
to make you keep that shit. You're not going to pay for a month, you know, do the free trial, watch what you need to watch. Get all about. In 3 nights.
Right.
And you out of there.
Use
man.
A new email. Boom, here we go. But you got to switch the card up, too. I heard
so
about
what about,
that
like, what do you think if they did, like, some shit like... So, like, the UFC, right? They put the regular, like, the prelims and stuff like that on regular TV.
Mm-hmm.
And then to get, like, the main event, you need pay-per-view. So what happens if you're watching a series and you pay your regular price for Netflix and you can watch the series, but to watch the season finale, you got to pay extra. Would you? You watch the whole series.
Damn. I mean, probably, yeah, depending. I
it's
mean,
like,
it depends
$5.
On how much extra it is.
Like $5.
Eh,
like
that's
a
not
movie,
bad.
Like a movie
that's
rental
not bad.
Fee.
That's not bad. Nah.
Or even if it was like, what's Redbox?
Unlock it now.
What's Redbox? Or that, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You pay like, five you more it. Dollars, you get the whole seasons now instead of having to wait week for week.
That's kind of true. That'd
there's
be smart.
Be,
that would
be there
smart
has to
right
be
there.
A capitalization
you know
on it,
see?
Bro. There has to be a capitalization
look at you.
On
look
the
you.
Income.
Look at you with your thinking hat on and shit.
Yeah, let's go, man.
I mean, hey, dog. You know how to write code for naps?
Absolutely not.
No, we need to find somebody, dog.
I'm gonna have to hit up Rubik's. I think he thank made a game. I think he made a game the other
he
day.
He did. Yeah, he did. Made a video game, man.
Fucking game.
Game
over.
I have still him, yet bro. To have gone to what's that bar called that he DJs at?
Mr. Heads? No, not Mr. Heads. He's at
Yeah, it's the Hut.
The Hut. The Hut.
Yeah, he's at the Hut.
I'm gonna cut all that bullshit out.
Shit, bro. Even I forgot too.
I've
been there a couple
like
times.
I've been there once
I been there
just
since,
to grab a beer.
I haven't been there since he's been working there. I've been there back in the day,
right.
But I haven't been there lately. But yeah, we're going to have to go check Ruby's out and talk to him and shit. We got some ideas coming, brewing some Hood Diner shit. The other thing, I don't know if you guys saw it, but they dropped the Bad Boys for Life trailer.
I haven't watched it yet.
Did you see that? You haven't seen it either? It's pretty good. It looks good. It's some Mike Lowry, some shit. It's good. It's good. They got some funny shit going on, some good action and stuff. You know what I'm saying? But, okay. So, wrapping up movies and TV.
Have you seen Chappelle's stand-up?
I saw some of it.
The new one?
I saw some of it. I had to cut it off.
Why is that?
I had to take a break. It was just, it's brutally honest. It's brutally honest.
It was way brutally
you know?
Honest.
And, like, there's some things that he was talking about that I can't fully relate to.
Okay.
You know, as far as like color, you know what I'm saying? Like I cut it off right after the what was it? The HR thing, the part of it that went viral where he's like, you can't say the F word,
yeah, you can,
but you can say nigger on like, you know
right?
what I'm saying? And I don't know how this is going on a podcast, but yeah.
No, but you know what?
I cut it off right after that.
Okay. But that carries some weight.
100%.
Like
I got you.
It's true, though. How is it a double standard? Like, it's almost to the point where, like, I understand the oppression that the whole homosexual movement, you know, all that stuff. But it's like, there is a double standard. They'll drop the even the A part, you know? They'll drop the N-word with the A on TV, and it's cool, you know what I'm saying? But
right.
You'll get canceled if you drop, you know, any homophobic slur.
I think it's because it's still a...
Go ahead.
Still Dr. fresh to most people. You know, people can say, like, the issues with African-Americans have been ongoing for so long that we're used to it. We're used to hearing about that type of stuff.
Right.
But as far as the coming out for the rights and things of that nature for that community, mm-hmm. you know, it's still kind of fresh to the American people.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
I mean, I think that's why. Shit was barely legalized as far as, like, marriage in a lot of states, you know what I'm saying?
30 years from now, you're talking about, like, that shit can be played around, most likely, because people are going to be done being sensitive about it. They're going to know, like, the difference in the ideas and shit.
People are extra
sensitive. But you look at media, even from 15 years ago, and homophobia wasn't even an issue back then. You know what I'm saying?
Until it came to Eminem.
Right.
You know, and certain things in the forefront. But, no, you're right. You're right.
So you turn it off at that point.
I turned it off at that point, yeah.
Okay, so fashion and culture.
Damn!
I saw some sick-ass fucking... I haven't been buying no Jordans and shit lately, dog, but my one of my favorite Jordans of all time has been the Jordan 4 Toro, like the red one,
absolutely,
right?
Absolutely, the red and black with the white sole.
The red, and then it's got the fucking little gray on the wing on the side of shit.
Yeah!
Let me show you these ones that came out. They're called the fucking Jordan 4 FIBAs. These are fucking cold, bro. Hold on.
But camo 10s are coming out this weekend.
Yeah, dog. It's like apparently like some sort of like flag embossed type shit, like of different. There you go. Exactly.
But don't be afraid of talking to Mike.
Oh, shit. I thought he was cutting through. Me and my bad. Right, yeah, no, those are super fresh. But I honestly, it's been.
They look like U of A ones.
I can't even say that.
Do.
You know someone's gonna wear them. Yeah, someone's gonna wear them at the
U of A. But I'm a Sun Devil all
it's
day.
It's good
though,
that you brought that up, considering you're an Arizona fan.
Nah, bro.
Never, not once.
Nah, I actually, that was like the only reason that I didn't want to come on the shows because I knew that. Right? And he's a Suns fan.
I appreciate you, man. I appreciate you.
Are you
looking
like
past
are you like a Suns fan?
Oh, for sure.
As well.
Sure.
Okay, yeah. No, you know why I hate the Suns? Because of Steve Nash. Does that boil your blood?
Because of Steve Kerr. That fool became the GM and fucked our team off. Took over Mark Jackson's team. Now he's the best coach to ever do the game. Fuck that.
Hey, man, you got to find your role, man. That. Maybe that the GM position wasn't his role.
Yeah, but yeah, out of man. My fucking no, account, you know what I'm saying?
I'm not a Suns fan. Best thing that ever came out of ASU was James Harden, so I love you forever for that.
Okay, Eddie House is a little, yeah. You know.
Huh?
Eddie House?
Who? James Harden.
You better stop.
Eddie House is a coach out there, though, in Phoenix, right? And his son plays out there?
His son plays for ASU too, dog. Like, we got some things brewing in Tempe.
Yeah, it's still not looking good.
Better than it has been.
Hey, Nico Mannion.
I hear that.
Nico Mannion, man.
Remy Martin's a beast, though.
Nico Mannion. Who got more views on YouTube right now?
That's cool.
I guarantee you it's Nico.
Wait, but you're playing with little boys. You know
hey, man,
what
we're
saying?
We're going viral.
You're a hooper, right?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So, you know, like, in high school, it's tight. You can be a blue chipper. He's an AAU. He's a fucking five-star, no doubt.
Yeah,
I give
absolutely.
Him his props. But it's a different thing when you got all – there's all five stars you're playing against. You know what I'm saying? Because especially in the pack.
Yeah, but Nico's in that level where he's already playing with all these guys he's going to
well,
play
feel
against
like that.
Next
I feel like if he's elite, he'll
so
show it.
So that's not going to be a
he'll
jump.
Show it.
The
he'll
only thing that's going to fuck him up is the crowd. I mean, he's already playing big games, but you going from like sold-out high school to sold-out like
– arenas.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So that might be the only thing that might freak him out. But, I mean, I trust in his game, man. He's solid. He's got a nice little mid-range, which is
well, this is the thing is great. That you guys are coming off of a non-NCAA, non-NIT appearance. No, but that's an important thing. There's,
yeah, but we're not talking about that right now.
There's no foundation there. There's no momentum going forward. You guys are just a brand-new nucleus. What if these kids can't play together?
It's never been about that for them.
I'm just throwing all the variables out there. You know what I'm saying?
That's true. But, I mean... If you were in that position, would you care about just getting through the season?
I just don't think Sean
sure
Miller's
don't
a good
get
enough
injured,
coach.
And you can get that. I think he's a great coach, and I think he's going
to
be coaching
I think
the
he's
NBA.
A great recruiter, but as far as coaching, he can't get him to the promised land. He can't, what, pass the Elite Eight?
You can't. A coach can only go so far.
For
man.
Sure.
A coach can only
but
go so far.
But you got to talk about paying $100,000.
That's still fucking good, man.
No, not for U of A. Is that good for U of A? You accept that?
I don't accept it.
No,
but
no.
There's definitely a lot worse.
There's upside.
Going on.
Yeah, there's upside to everything.
So,
but at
yeah.
the end of the day, you're a rapper,
you're
a hip hopper, so you'll want to be the best at your craft, right?
100%. Yeah,
but and you're a hooper too, so you can't not attest that you want to win the chip.
So there's still the stigma, though. Like if you go to Kansas or if you go to Duke,
ASU swept Kansas 2 years in a row.
There we go. I believe you.
Hey,
cool, man.
They still got like. Three, four, and at times, 5, 6 guys from that freshman recruiting team going to the league.
No doubt.
So if you even have the chance, because most likely U of A has grown so much as a brand that if you get a U of A scholarship, I would probably say about maybe like 60 to 70% of the time, chances. You got a scholarship offer to Kansas or Duke as well.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, so what are you going to take? You're going to take the percentage to where it's like, they sending 4 or 5 guys to the league next year. Or are you going to take the one for the U of A where usually it's been about one straight to the league at a good pick. The other couples kind of like have to trickle in. Alonzo Trier, you know, great fucking story. You know, didn't make the draft, train, tryout, you know, all that stuff. And now he's killing it.
We had two players last year do that. Zylan Cheatham and Lou Dort.
No,
Dort's playing with
saying.
The Thunder. Cheatham's playing with the Pelicans.
I'm gonna still take it. If but, I'm a kid from anywhere else and I got the choice between U of A and ASU from
the
records right now, no, they're coming here, bro.
Mm-hmm. No, for sure. They're for sure. Here. U of A all day.
You know
for
what I'm
real.
Saying?
Bear down.
But that's what I say.
Hurley is changing the culture over there. He is getting some top prospects in. Gotta get out of the first round.
I believe you.
You gotta get out of the first round.
Hey, I ain't get this tattoo for nothing. It's gonna happen.
Hey, Doc. No, I'm just saying. I just like a conscious conversation about it because I don't like people that
see,
are.
See, this is the thing. See, now you're gonna make me Drake. You're gonna make me Drake these U of A games, man. When we play ASU, man, I'm gonna be on that front court. I'm gonna be right there on the sideline, man.
Honestly, one of my bucket lists is to sit in Wells Fargo Arena courtside for that game.
That's fire. That'll happen, man. You did the vacation. You can do this.
Oh, all day.
You just got to want to do it.
Oh, yeah, all day.
Tell them what you're doing now with the ASU games. Oh, that's football, though, huh?
Football. Right now, we got media passes for the Skybox.
Word.
For the football games.
Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you. I'm not going to go to the Sacramento State, huh?
Tell them what
you're
doing.
We're just doing journalism. Like, I'm just a spotter. I'm not going to be writing articles, I found out.
Really?
But it's going to be aiding, like stats, keeping and all that shit, so it'll probably lead to more. But I'm going to get to watch the games for free, dog.
That's fucking sick.
Wild.
You know what I'm saying?
And
that's
ASU's balling in football, too, doggy. Got Irm
up
there.
I don't watch football.
We got Irm Edwards up there.
I don't watch football, man. I don't watch football.
Well, moving on.
Man, we're okay. Talking about football. Football's back. Today
sports.
Was the first game.
Sports. We're getting into sports. Football is back. I did the fucking fantasy draft. I had no fucking clue what I was doing.
You drafted a pretty solid team.
I just remember you saying you were just like, fucking just get Brady, dude. And somehow I fucking got him. And I didn't even get him on purpose. I got him through the fucking auto drafting. Like, it gave me fucking Brady, right?
Well, I knew you were going to get Patrick Mahomes.
I didn't know to get him. You should have said.
No, there's no way you were going to get him.
You should have fucking told me to try to get certain players,
right,
dog.
Right.
I would have tried it. But I figured it out like after like a fucking couple auto drafts watching what it was doing.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, okay. And then these fools were in the fucking chat and they were like talking about who they're going to be getting. Or they were like, I think we were FaceTiming and shit. And I was just listening to what they're doing and shit. And they started fucking mentioning a couple names and shit. And he's like, dude, if nobody gets fucking such and such, I'm going to get him and fucking this and that. I didn't fall for that on all of them, but I did watch the stats and I looked at them and I was like, all right, yeah, this running back dude looks like the only one good available with those some decent numbers and shit. I've never done fantasy football drafts, bro, ever.
Never in my life.
Never, ever done it and shit. So I was like, we with our homies from the Inner Circle, we have a podcast network, 7 of us. Yeah! We all roll together. We fucking share each other's shit, build each other up and shit like that, dog. We got a nice little website and shit, dog. They help. They push the official brand for me and shit too, dog. It's fucking
fire.
It's cool, man.
This
you
is like the first year in 10 years I didn't draft a fucking team.
Well, I did it. I don't know what I did, but I don't even know how the fuck it works. But I'm gonna give you the shit so you can log into it and you can like maneuver players around or trade or whatever the fuck you got to do. Okay.
Do
so
what
get that
the
shit.
Fuck you wanna do.
Okay, so in sports, I also read something that said LeBron is trying to patent the phrase Taco Tuesday.
Yeah, but he better stop eating them trash-ass tacos.
Right?
The ones he be posting aren't tacos, dog.
You don't think so? What? No. You don't think he can afford good tacos?
I don't. That's not even the question. But what's on his plate ain't taco. That ain't it, Chief. That's what I'm saying.
You think they're homemade?
I think whoever catered or whatever the fuck that he had on his plate when he was Taco Tuesday was trash.
One more time?
It was trash, dog.
No, on one plate. More time. What'd you say?
Taco Tuesday. Smartest fuck, gears, though. Bro. Smartest fuck. Absolutely. Trademark the fucking term.
It's like, kinda fucked up.
It's not. No, it's smart. He already filed.
I don't think he can, though.
Hey, dog. Whether he gets accepted or not, they already filed the proper paperwork to get it trademarked.
That's
so
fucking crazy.
It's kind of fucked up, but at the same time, LeBron's the kind of dude that would use all that money to, like,
build
a new Amazon.
Something like that, right? Like, new fucking school.
He would do something like
there.
Absolutely incredible. So it's probably not like he's going to be, like, bougie with the money.
Planting 12 million trees.
Yeah.
Something,
you know,
like
what I'm
that.
Saying?
Ain't nothing wrong with that. So, also today, I don't know if you guys saw it, but Antonio Brown is suspended due to an altercation with the general manager. So he got into it with the boss, basically, right? Is what I gather.
The big deal is that it's fucking with this $30 million guaranteed now.
Okay.
That's
but
the
just,
bigger.
But from missing just one game, or is that what they've all these? Have they said how many games?
There's so many incentives involved with that $30 million guaranteed. Those contracts are bulletproof now, you know? You don't just sign and they're like, oh, well, you broke your leg. Cool. It's all good. That Andrew Luck situation, there's a lot of money that was supposed to be paid back to Indianapolis that didn't get paid back. And they're just like, we're washing our hands with Andrew Luck.
Yeah, they're giving him his money, right?
They're letting, yeah, paying him out and that's it. But
he got booed on his fucking own fucking, on his own fucking field.
It came out wrong, though. It came out so wrong. In the preseason game, they had leaked it. Andrew Luck is retiring. And then it's all, boo! Do they start throwing shit at him or no?
Oh, fuck, I don't know. I hope not.
That would be so whack, bro.
Some foul shit, man.
The dude got a degree from Stanford. He's going to be fine.
No, I'm sure he will.
You know?
So, yeah, man. And then only other thing I got in sports, pretty dope. Serena Williams, she got her 101 fucking win at the U.S. Open and her 10th U.S. Open win.
That's fire.
That's fucking dope, man. Like, she's been killing that shit. That's so cool, man. Like, she's just fucking, she's been holding that shit down for a minute.
But she's like on mom duty now and still performing at a high level. That's what's sick.
Yeah. So shout out to her.
You know, you ever watch her body issue for ESPN?
Nah.
Ooh wee. I'm saying.
I feel it.
Oh my god.
I'm saying, you know. That's why when you see girls, and I am not shaming anybody. It's 2019. Do what you want to do. You know what I'm saying? But when they get those butt injections, like
terrible.
The thighs don't match.
Absolutely terrible.
You know what I'm saying?
Bro.
Like, the thighs don't match. So, like, when I tell, like, females when I'm talking about, like, because, like, what do you how do you know that they got booty fillers? And I pull up a picture of Serena Williams. And while that's what happens when you have a huge butt.
Yeah.
The thighs match it's a ratio. You know what I'm saying?
True. Mm.
I'm just speaking game, natural. You know, and I'm not even being a pervert or a sexist or feminist, but it's just like I've seen a lot of.
You don't even gotta say that shit because when you say it, it makes you sound guilty.
Well,
it kind of does.
If that's a form of guilt, a mission of guilt, then shit, you know. Sorry,
nah, man, but it's a true thing.
I've seen a lot of naked butts in my day.
This is true,
and
legend.
From what I can concur off of my scientific research of studying the woman's body, is that the thighs match the booty most of the time.
Okay,
but I'm not opposed to the skinny thighs either. I mean, hey, we all, you know, it's all about love.
Everybody got to live,
you know.
Okay, are you a fan of watches? What you got? Right, what are you rocking right there?
Nah, man, this is a gift from a loved one.
Okay,
you know what I'm saying? It's one of those handmade joints with the inscription on the inside.
Okay, yeah. Hey, no, that's fine. Just
I've never really been the one. The only type of jewelry that I really do enjoy are rings. I really enjoy rings.
Yeah. I fucking love rings. But this is like a G-Shock put out it's kind of like a minimalist style of like the normal G-Shocks. It's not too like big and fucking all in your face and shit. Like, it's kind of clean.
Oh, that's hard.
You know what I'm saying? It's pretty nice. It's a basic version of what
I like when they show the innards.
The G-Shocks, the innards.
That's gross.
But anyway, and it comes at
fucking gross.
They only come in at fucking $99 too, because most of the G-Shocks are like $150, $140 for the big ass faces and shit like that. This one doesn't have as big of a face, but it's
okay,
it's pretty,
okay, yeah,
it's cleaner.
It's
you know what I'm saying?
Joint,
it's clean, you know what I'm saying? I still fuck with my little thing, my little fucking, what do you call it? The fucking Apple Watch.
Real talk, all I want is a plain Jane Rolly.
That's
little 5-6 grand. That's it, bro. Like, I don't want no diamonds. The problem is I like the yellow gold. And those start at like 18,000.
I'm not even looking at numbers like that.
No, no, me either. I don't got that. I mean, shit, we could hope one day to, you know.
I'm barely looking at $180.
Right. It's just that's a timepiece that's going to like maintain its value no matter what.
That's true. That's very true. That's very true.
And you got to have like some money come in real quick.
Yeah.
You could sell it for $5,000 less and still come up. You know what I'm saying?
All right, man. So moving on. Show love and no love for this week. What you got for show love?
Showing
and no
love, the fucking football's back, man.
Okay, this is true.
I'm a huge football fan.
I concur.
Like, I don't even subscribe to like cable during football season being off because it's like I could care less about.
Yeah, but you can watch it with what is it? Switch. What is it called?
Sling.
Sling.
Well, that's why I subscribe with Sling. I'm really big into college football.
Gotcha.
I love the fucking decadence of it, like the fucking jerseys are clean.
The decadence.
The fucking marching bands, like Ohio State's marching bands, the illest marching band in the nation. They always do those crazy ass formations and shit. The games, like it's just you see kids that are gonna be in the NFL soon. It's just like it's the hunger.
Oh no, absolutely.
The hunger to be
that's
the
college
best,
any sport.
You know?
You know? Cause that little extra effort is gonna make their family good for generations to come.
I just, you know what I'm saying?
They want that. You don't have another chance after that.
Make or break, basically.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you see the level of competition so high that it's just like, man. And now there's a little bit of parity now that Alabama's just not cruising the championships anymore.
This is
still Clemson moving, right? And we're moving. Moving and grooving.
Okay, definitely. Memes of the week, dog.
Well, no love for you.
I don't really have a no love this week. I got none but love for everybody this week.
None but love for you, baby.
I feel that.
Right? And my memes of the week.
Nice meme.
This week, I thought it'd be funny. Obviously, that I post them up on the Twitter and shit, and I put them on the Instagram stories. But I thought that this one was funny. They're both actually have fucking Homer Simpson on them. And this one says, why does it take you so long to respond? Are you texting other people? And it says me, like sparking up a joint.
Right, yeah. You
know, I see
I can relate to that.
That one. And then look at this one right here.
That's wild. Right? That's a good one. That's a good one.
It's a picture of Peter Griffin and fucking Homer Simpson looking at you. But the top, it says three stoners looking at each other. I had to think about it too. I was like, wait a minute. Three. Oh,
that's very deep. You know, yeah, it's very deep.
It's like the ha ha right there. You know what I'm saying? But okay. So I kind of forgot to tell you that we do this show. I mean, if you've listened, you know we do this shit called Jams of the Week, where we try to share a song that we've just been put on, like since the week that we last recorded and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Well, gotcha.
It keeps us trying to find newer shit. You know what I'm saying? Lucky for me, my Jam of the Week is by this gentleman right here.
Hey.
Because he just dropped a jam called Run featuring Mr. Aske and Mr. Vinney Mendez.
Yes,
who have also been on the podcast. Shout out to them and shit. But yeah, man, that's a fire ass track.
Thank you, bro.
I fucking love that shit.
I can't forget, man. It was produced by Counted by Chris.
And Counted by Chris. Yes, that's right, man.
One of the illest young cats that I've heard in a very, very long time out here. The kid is hungry for this.
He's got some fire.
All of them
beats,
are,
man.
Shout out to Vinny. Me and Vinny been, man, I can't even say how long, man, we've been rocking with each other. And then definitely Aske, you know. I got a different vibe with Aske.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Aske's like, he's turned into like a real little bro, you know, kind of dude. That whole camp, but There's something with Aske, man. That I really rock with the kid, man.
He's
like,
a cool cat,
real,
man. I fuck with Aske. He came he, when I did this just like a couple weeks ago. We had that barber battle. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Molly and them, the Desert Storm barber battle, the King of the Ring, and Calvin Jarvis. He performed that day.
Yes, he did.
Fucking, you were there.
I was in there.
Performed that day.
Yeah,
and
I was in there.
Jamal was there. You know, holding down the fort with me and shit like that. But yeah, dude, I talked to Aske that day. He came, he approached me, we talked about some cool shit.
What did he say? He goes, I hate when people call me. What was it?
Aske. Yeah, he said he don't like that. But I show him some love too. Yeah, he came to me on some cool shit, man. And like, he's just very, he's very zoned in on what he wants to accomplish right now. You know what I'm saying? So got to give Absolutely. Him some definite love to Aske and shit.
And I'm positive it was with y'all when, because I was listening to the interview when you was asking him about the Tucson scene and whatnot. Mm-hmm. And he said, I think his exact words were somewhere along the lines of, I got fucking tired of seeing Tommy Will and Easy going performing at every show. And I was like,
God damn.
I was like, you know what? Shit, I would be too, bro. Would be too, man. Yeah. Like, Easy was getting booked at the Rialto, like, shit. I want to say at least once a month, if not twice.
Right.
He went through a binge, I want to say like a year and a half ago, where this man would tell me he got booked at the Rialto like every two weeks.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it was wild. So I had to stop and think once I heard him say it, because I laughed. I was like, that's wild.
Dude.
And then I took back and I was like, man, like, we did a stretch where we was there a lot. You know what I'm saying? And it turned out not to be the way to go. So,
hell yeah, man.
I definitely tell him, don't do all that.
But yeah, man, that's my jam of the week and shit like that.
Much love, man.
And this, my old school jam of the week, it was crazy because I was able to, Shazam it? Because I looked for the soundtrack of the show on iTunes and I couldn't fucking find it, right? So I found the name of the song, and then I found her with her own shit, but it's called Sugar. And the name of the song is called What's Up, Star? I don't know if you remember this song. Watch.
It sounds like one of those fucking...
Listen. They sample this right here. I think it offends you because somebody makes it, so somebody gotta spend it. Like, they've, a lot of songs have sampled that shit, like for the hooks and shit like that. But like, this is the hook. Right? I don't know if you haven't heard it. It's definitely an older track, but it was on, that's where I know it from. It was on the soundtrack of the show. Had that song by Tupac called My Block. It had Everyday Thang by Bone Thugs and Harmony. Do you ever remember that song? It's an everyday thing when you let your nuts hang. You ever remember that shit?
Yeah.
Also had the LBC crew with the Summertime in the LBC.
Oh yeah.
Like, that was just a fire ass fucking soundtrack, but it was for a movie that was put together by Def Jam. Yeah, the show. You know what I'm talking about. So the soundtrack was dope as fuck, and I've never heard that chick anywhere else, but I found her fucking like singles, because when I went to the album and shit, it was literally just a single, but it also had the instrumental, it had the acapella.
It had it like five ways.
I was like, damn, I didn't know they had that shit on fucking iTunes. I was like, that's kind of cool, because I love that beat, dog. Like, shit, I would rock the fuck out of that beat right there. But anyways, so yeah, man, so like, is there something that you've heard this past week, something that's new to you that you can share with the listeners, like that they can listen to, find on iTunes or Spotify or shit like that? Something new?
Man, I don't really, just because I've been creating so much, I haven't really been trying to tap in with too many people, because I
kind of
got to
tell you, got to, like,
influence
take a break,
over
huh?
myself.
Right,
yeah, like,
right.
There's times, man, like, I don't know. I kind of feel strongly about it, I guess, at a point. You know, I don't feel like artists should even listen to any type of music of their own genre while they're trying to create their own album.
Kind of,
I just don't feel like it would be fully you. Because even if you don't know that you're saying it, sometimes you're saying something.
Subliminal, you start writing some shit because it sounds something
that
like
you've already heard.
I've been there.
You just
I've
don't
done
remember.
That.
You just don't recall. You know, that happened with me and Isaiah Rashad. You know, I listened to a bunch of Isaiah Rashad. Then I started working on some music. I made a hook and I was like, yo, that was like, this is banging. And then, like, I mixed it, kind of left it there, see what I wanted to do with it. I'm on Spotify, Pandora, whatever I was on. I heard that a song come on by Isaiah Rashad, damn near identical hooks. I had no idea.
Oh shit!
It was that one. I don't remember what he said.
It's like a subliminal thing. Like, it happens.
No,
like
it is.
You don't
it
even know.
Absolutely
yeah.
is. Because right. my hook was like. It's like, and I'm down for my niggas, my homies, my brothers, my dogs, and my something. And then I
it's
was like
a certain melody stays in your head, but there's no words there. You know,
it was
you,
damn near the
you
same.
You put your own words instead.
But
yeah.
it was damn near close, because he said something for my niggas, my homies, my, and it was the same cadence and everything. And I was like, I had no idea. So it's kind of like a hit or miss thing, and that's why I say, like, don't listen to shit. Yeah. So now, I mean, I don't really have anything besides
Boogie. Well, what about some old school song that you just, like,
something
absolutely
old school?
Love?
I went back and I listened to some Ludacris because it was big on Twitter that people was like mad hating, bro. They was like, y'all want another Ludacris album? Like, you know, it's other
I saw
shit.
That I trended.
Like, bro, yeah.
I saw I that like, trend for some reason.
Bro,
I was like
hell yeah, I would love another Ludacris album. That type of energy, the fact that Missy came out with a new album recently.
Yeah.
Wild.
Why not?
Wild.
Right?
I would love to hear a new Ludacris album, a new Nelly album.
Fuck yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like that type of, you know, even like a new Lil Flip album, like.
Right,
and he might have because I've heard.
I actually heard he was doing some shit. Yeah, that's right.
You know what I'm saying?
I did hear about that recently too.
These kind of things, man. I don't know. I get hyped for that.
So what song? What's like your favorite old school Ludacris?
I would probably say like probably top two, Throw Them Bowls.
Yeah.
Splash Waterfalls.
Yep. I love the fucking Splash Waterfalls remix. They brought in fucking Tony.
Yeah.
Whatever you want. Yeah, they fucking flipped the shit out of that shit.
Oh,
dude.
Yeah.
That shit was beautiful. What about you, Doug? What you got this week?
My new jam is a song from PNB Rock. I Like Girls featuring Lil Skies. Okay. It's just one of them club bangers.
You just heard that?
I barely started playing it.
Playing it? Does it not do well?
It's still like,
it's still making its rounds.
Yeah, yeah. You know so I mean, I don't know if a lot of people have heard it yet or what, but for me, I barely came across it. Started throwing it. I like it's a knocking beat. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
It's a nice like, I want to say time waster, but just a turn up song. You know?
Yeah, it can keep the vibe going.
Yeah.
I like that record. I like that record a lot.
Yeah. So that's my new jam of the week. And then my throwback is. I hadn't played 2 Chainz in so long.
Legend. He just started a G League team.
Yeah. Oh, really?
What? Yeah, a G League team.
Oh no shit.
Yeah, he just started one. The okay. The College Park. Oh man, Skyhawks.
That's what's up.
The College Park Skyhawks.
Okay.
Yeah, they're gonna be the G League team of the Atlanta Hawks.
That's dope. Yeah.
Dope.
I'm different from his different. Based on a True Story.
Okay. Hey, okay.
Album. That song hits, bro. Mustard. Mustard's probably one of the nicest fucking producers out right now. He's been doing it for a while. People count him out, and he still comes back with slappers, you know?
Absolutely.
But I really like that Bay Area sound that Mustard has. And been listening to a lot of Shoreline Mafia lately.
Shoreline?
Yeah,
Shoreline Mafia. Yeah.
Like S.O.B., R.B.
Yeah. I did a show with them recently.
Yeah, bro. Nice. I like Young T.O.,
Young T.O., yeah, no, he's solid. He's solid. He wasn't like, there.
Oh, no?
He wasn't there, and it was just because it was the same. It was the day. No, it was the day Nipsey Hussle passed.
Oh, word.
It had to have been like the day after. I think it was the day after, but it was definitely like within 2 or 3 days of that because he didn't show up for that because he was at like the marathon store like with everybody, okay. You know, and all that stuff because him and Nipsey were close.
Oh, word.
You know, okay. You know, I don't know how close. Of course, I don't know him.
Yeah, right.
You know, but from what they were saying on stage, the other members, they was like, yeah, it was like he couldn't make it. You right. know?
Yeah, man. I just like that sound of the Bay.
Yeah,
it's just different. You know what I'm saying?
Pilo, you a Pilo fan? With I Am Sue?
Oh yeah, I mean, you know, I'm not big on I Am Sue.
But Pilo is like the Asian homie.
Okay.
Yeah, you got to look him up. He's fire, super dope producer. And rapper.
Okay.
He's got some records on NBA 2K.
Who's the homie that is out of Long Beach?
Larry June.
No, that dude's
I don't know if he's out of Long Beach, but
he's an Asian Larry dude. He's a rapper.
Shorty Young? Young,
They did like a Vice article on him.
It's Stupid Young. Stupid Young,
yeah.
He's like a Crip, huh? Isn't
yeah,
he a Crip
he's
too?
An Asian Crip. Yeah.
Yeah, I saw that article too.
Stupid
yeah,
Young.
Okay.
Fire music.
Fuck yeah.
That's Mando.
As Mando, yeah. It was one of my jams of the week.
Do you play that at Cobra?
I can.
If I come on Saturday, you gotta play that.
Okay.
All
right. I play whatever I want. Like
I feel
last
that.
Sunday,
you
I
don't
played
play my music though.
I played The Cure. Hey. Shots fired.
On that note, we're gonna take a little break real quick. So you know what I'm saying? Take a little breather.
Okay.
A little fresh air. And yeah, man. After these messages, we'll be right back.
Yeah. Hey. No fighting, I'ma shoot it out. All these niggas looking pump fake. Still ducking that leg day. I can tell you never pump weight. Put all my trust in the A. My girl said I'm stuck in my ways. I brought my life to the table. Why you looking empty handed? Either you in or you out. I'll never pay the fence. Don't get no higher than this. This is as real as it gets. 850, we think it's thieves. Down for my brothers, we got the same enemies. Name a time that I backed down. Oh, these niggas still breathing. Let me swing this bitch back round. They ask me why I'm like this. My mom gone and my aunt gone. Got me feeling like a flight risk. Ammo for the chef's Sandy. Tommy loaded, I'm a coffin. Got it looking like a blood bag. Yeah, bitch, in the mall in it. Told Chris we gon' take off. It's 8 gang to the world gone. To it, never run from it. Now it's all paid, only go fund it. Put a price on it, bet they won't pay it. Cause it's all said to the boy, done it. Want a ball shorty, getting tall money. Got a bag full, bet it's all hundreds. Blue faces like I've been talking. Ben Franklin, out of prayers on it. Got a nails pressed, feel the pressure. Now I'm putting my time in. All stride, nothing less than effort. Out here trying to make diamonds. It was accidental, like I crashed the rental. Chris counted on the instrumental. Tell them A&Rs, I wanna raise the bar. And you better send me my incidentals. Keep it score, you can keep counting. Wildcats and Catalina Mountains. Now Catalina got a bigger bank and a daddy gotta get a new accountant. Pool fountains with a cup of water. Now I'm feeling like the fucking Carter. Blood full of that gasoline. Now I'm feeling like a fire starter. 5 stars in this rap shit. Told my daddy I'm a bastard. Ask you next if you ask me. Tell Tommy Will we got a classic. Phone jumping like an acrobat. Lyrics doing gymnastics. That's all facts. As a matter of fact, had a whole city doing backflips.
Yeah. Yeah. The music came straight from the Holy Grail. Only fail if I choose it. Pen is swift as a saber. I thought I wrote this in a Buick. If I focus, I pursue it. Cemetery on a grave shit. But most of you niggas that had a chance, but blew it like you never saved shit. I'm coming alive in the nighttime. The zombie apocalypse. You like the opposite. You never pop it, so keep all the compliments. I got no options. It comes with the confidence. I ain't no almost rapper. This ain't no almost did it. Only almost was your rapping. How I almost dig it. I never fake the effort when it's ate up like a Kobe jersey in the Staples Center. They gotta hate forever. Yeah, Vinny spazzing, it's the aftershock. Record sounding like it's rap a lot. Light shining like a traffic stop. God level like a Kakarot, and it's the 5, nigga. It's the 5, nigga.
You know, we completely skipped something new today.
Well, let's talk about it.
Let's talk about something new real quick. This week was my week.
Yummy.
This week, something new. It was my week. I found these fucking Oreos, right?
Destroyed those bitches.
Chocolate peanut butter pie. I've never seen them before. They were brand new. I was like, dude, we got to try these shits, all right? They're pretty much gone. I'm saving like the last 3. I'm going to take them home to my lady so she can try them shits.
Got
to
do it. You know, fire.
Right there.
If you see them, cop those.
Fuck yeah. And, dude, I love Hurrican's fucking popcorn. We were talking about this on the actual Patreon video. But Hurrican's put out some kettle corn. You can hear DJ Century chomping on it over
You know
there.
Those holiday tins?
Yeah.
Way better than this one.
Really? Yeah. Like that? Yeah. Damn.
Damn.
That's a big old fucking stamp of no approval, but yeah, you're
Use
stuffing
this,
your fucking
they
face.
They ain't gonna let you at Hurrican's no more after this, bro.
Yeah. I mean,
damn. This, you were fucking, you were.
You already know
up.
I stuck my own gummies in that bitch already. You know, weed gummies. That is
smoke weed every day.
Anyways, I went to the Hurrican's the other day. You know what they had that was fire? I hadn't had one in a really long time. And like me and my lady shared it. A fucking pretzel.
I don't get the salt though.
You?
I
what? Didn't. We got the salt,
bro.
It was light. It was light. But oh. It was fucking nice, dog. It was nice and warm and shit. And they give you this little jalapeno cheese and shit, dude. I was like, okay, Hurrican's, I see you.
I'll get a plain pretzel. I just won't do the salt.
Hurrican's was fucking killing it with
that's
the fucking
whack.
Thing like that. But
I'm not going to lie. That's kind of whack.
Bro, they fucking drowned
like,
in
why
salt.
Why get a pretzel then?
No, I get it, bro. But
right?
You feel like
why,
you have a salt rock
it?
In the
why
back
put
of your mouth.
Through it? You know the thing about pretzels, bro? I love pretzels. but the smell of Wetzel's pretzels, and it's only Wetzel's pretzels.
Fucks with you.
In the mall makes me nauseous.
Really?
Bro, it makes me absolutely nauseous, bro. I feel like I can smell that shit from like halfway through the mall.
I'm thinking of Aunt Maddie's. I'm thinking of Aunt Maddie's. That's the one I see in the airport.
No, not that one.
I see that one in the airport.
Literally only Wetzel's pretzels, bro. As soon as I walk into a mall, if I've never been there, I can smell it. I'm like, there's a Wetzel's pretzels around here, bro.
Yeah, we're walking around. We're going the long way.
I don't like the smell of Abercrombie and Fitch cologne.
Smells like white privilege. Oh, shit.
It's just fancier.
You're onto something.
What is it? Fucking the Axe deodorant spray? It's like the next level up.
Nah, bro, I would say the next like, level down.
Like a grenade, bro. Okay. They break one open and throw it in the middle of the store. You know what I'm saying?
Man.
They spray Calvin Klein in that motherfucker.
The Harkins popcorn was all right. I liked it. I fucked with it. I was just surprised that they had it in the fucking store and shit. So
it's like the Taco Bell chips.
Right? Oh, we had them last week. Look at fire, you already bro. Saw these, right? Look at the bags are still here.
Okay, there you go.
You got
yeah.
the Diablos and shit.
It's all about branding.
All fucking chilling right there, and I didn't even fucking throw them away yet. Okay. And then, of course, we already talked about it. Talked about the fucking church's chicken sandwich. Talked about that. Yeah, apparently now they're out of production until like October something. It's kind of crazy.
They burned through a 7-week supply in 2 weeks.
So was it a fucking... So that's all they said? They were doing like a 7-week thing?
Okay. Well, that's all they were all prepared for, a 7-week... I guess campaign.
Inventory.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's all they bought, huh?
Well, that's all they had ready to cook, yeah.
Damn.
So
fucking burned through that shit. Did you try it?
I did try it.
Fire, what'd you think? Right?
It was cool. It was good. But
what
I
do
have,
you recommend that's better?
To be honest, we got new ones at Buffalo Wild Wings.
Oh shit. Look
we
at
got
you.
New ones
you
at Buffalo Wild Wings. Not going that's a super plug.
Super plug.
Super plug. Fire.
Good.
We have a southern chicken sandwich and we have a Nashville hot chicken sandwich.
Okay, that does sound good.
If you like spicy, go for the Nashville.
Okay.
Super fire.
Okay.
Chicken breast still thick. You know what I'm saying? Like pickled chips, all that good stuff on the sandwich, man. We got our own sauce on it. Pause. Like,
yeah.
It's fire. It's fire. Damn. But you're not going to get that for $4. That's the difference.
Oh, definitely.
That's the difference.
Definitely, definitely.
You got to understand your drive through and your sit down restaurants are two different prices.
100%. 100%. But if we talk about taste and like the craze, like, did they run out of the sandwiches? Absolutely not. Restaurants, most restaurants, and I don't know about fast food, but regular restaurants, sit down restaurants, your inventory is once a week. If you know you're going to get a big order, if a holiday's coming
up,
something
like that. This was a national wide epidemic, basically.
Right. But you can still make that order.
But if you have outlasted your supply, like you have a 7-week supply that you have on deck. We, due to logistics, we don't produce more than that. Because if this sandwich is a flop, we don't want that investment in all these sandwiches.
Yeah, but during that first week, they should have put that hit out. They should have been like, hey, dude, this is going to be crazy.
Right, but there's so much that goes into it. They got to grow those chickens that they're killing.
This is true.
You know what I'm saying?
That chicken. Sounds fucked up the way that you said that, but yeah, you're right.
I'm going to tell you this. The more
they
you know
kill
me,
those
dog.
Chickens. That you eating. It sounds fucked up.
The more
right.
you get
know,
to
you're
know me,
right.
you realize lady, I'm not a sugar
my lady
coder,
asked
you know
me that.
Saying?
She was like, how many wings do you get per chicken and shit? I was like,
two.
Four.
Four.
Four. Wings. Four. You get four wings. You get the drum and the fucking wing.
Okay.
And you get one from each
you
side.
You forgot about the drums.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You all flats. You all bought them flats?
Yeah,
no,
about
that
flat life.
I fuck with drummets.
Okay.
You know?
But yeah, that's what it takes. It's four for every okay, poor okay. every poor little chicken. The more you know, for the people out here listening that did not know
see,
that
Kez,
fact.
Kez tries to fuck with, like, get this guilt trip. Like, poor little piggies on the way to slaughter. They're shaking.
Hey, man. Well, I can't
oh
show a little
God.
Fucking
like,
sympathy
you know
and shit.
Are you
you're crazy. Huh?
You're not vegan. We
fuck, look at me. You think I'm a vegan?
So what you mean, poor little piggy?
Dude, okay. I saw a fucked up video last week on my
I
fucking Twitter. My homegirl showed me a fucking Twitter.
I believe you.
Dude, it's fucked up. And so that right there made me want to do it. But then this motherfucker talks about the fucking Cubano sandwich at Rolly's. And it sounded
you tried Rolly's?
See, I haven't.
You need to.
I'm so
I
mad
haven't
at
either.
Myself,
I haven't either.
I'm so
I haven't
mad
either.
At
don't be mad. I fucking known him from like since fucking
Mateo's a cool
young.
Dude.
Yeah.
What's the owner? Name? Mateo?
Yeah, we're going to be bringing him
shout
on hopefully
Mateo,
pretty soon
man.
And shit, man.
He just won. Best tacos
two years
in
a row.
Man.
Yeah, that's dope.
I'm gonna have
that's
to pull dope. Up, man. Don't hate me, Mateo. I'm
gonna
pull up.
I gotta pull up too. I want to bring him on the podcast. I want him to bring some food though.
shit. That's kind of fucked up too.
Nah, not like that. We'll buy it. I mean, you know,
you can do it in the back courtyard,
right there. Yeah, at bring a couple restaurant? Of those Cubanos right there. You want to record over there?
I'm down.
Nah, we could do that. I'm telling you, we got to get one of those Zoom 6 things.
We can set up
so we can
this.
Plug three fucking mics. This is too much.
No, hell
this
no.
This is way too much.
It's a studio quality. I'll transport it.
Okay. You set it up, too.
That's cool.
Sheesh.
I'm cool with that.
He's the engineer. He's the engineer.
Now,
I feel that.
I just appreciate a good quality setup. That's what I told this dude straight out the gate. We're not going to do this and sound like we're recording on a tape recorder and then uploading it to the internet. Like, we want CD quality. And I think if you listen to the episodes, you notice that it's pretty crispy. You know what I'm saying?
So how much local music do you turn off because of the quality?
Local music?
Yeah. I mean, you at a point in time, I'm pretty sure you got rappers sending you music.
Yeah, for sure. realistically, bro,
do you even go through it?
I don't come through a lot of bad artists because everybody I got put onto, he put me onto. So you're talking about Vinny Mendez. You're talking about you. You're talking about Jamal. You're talking about Shonuf, just Dorian. You know what I'm saying? Right. So, like, your homies are my homies. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I feel that.
Like, it's literally Marley B, Cash Lansky, Aske, I ride with now. You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of people. I was so fucking wet behind the ears when it came to Tucson hip hop prior to this podcast. Really, dog.
I feel that.
You know what I'm saying? So getting acclimated with all these people, like, it's tight because
that's why I keep these right here.
We fucking network, dog. And, like, if I can help out in any type of way, vice versa, you know what I'm saying? Like,
truth.
I might need that plug for a catering type of deal, you know what I'm saying? Like, I might hit you up for that type of shit. That's just a random example, but, like, someone might own a fucking plumbing business and my shitter's backed up, you know what I'm saying? So I hit them up. It's just one hand washes the other, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, man, make it's it huge. Forming positive fucking relationships, business relationships at that.
But as far as, like,
are the, fucking the quality, a good thing to do, you know what I'm saying?
I haven't really had any bad quality listens.
That's super dope.
Yeah, I
that's super dope.
Thankfully, everybody that's came to me has came correct.
That's awesome, man.
And to be honest with you, he does a lot of good scheduling of quality artists. You know what I'm saying? Like, we're nobody. We're no gatekeepers or nothing like that. But, like, we actually fuck with the people that we bring on here. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not, we don't get paid to bring people on. There's no, like, back end. Like, we just vibe with people. We bring them on straight up.
Straight up, man.
So that's why I'm glad that I haven't heard any whack rappers, and I haven't heard really any terrible engineering, you know?
So, that's fire. Super fire.
I guess with you, you have a lot of, I wouldn't say coworkers. What would be the right fucking term?
People in the same business.
There's people in the same scene doing the same thing as you.
Yeah.
They don't have the knowledge. You know what I'm saying?
A lot of artists hit you up. You know what I'm saying? And I'm sure a lot of artists have come through to Tommy, and you've listened to their shit, and you're kind of like...
And that's where you throw out them keys, man.
Yeah.
The keys I wish somebody would have thrown to me when I was 16, you know, 17. Like, I've been in, as far as involved in Tucson rap, hands-on, I'd say 8 years. Dude, but I've been rapping for 14 years, man.
That's beautiful, man. That was literally 14, my first question, bro. Right here. Yeah. That was literally the first question. 14 years. And when you started, you went by a different name, right?
I did.
What did you go by back then?
I was going by Giddy Gouda.
Giddy Gouda.
Giddy Gouda.
Fuck yeah.
I was a huge fan of Bay Area rap.
Right, right.
So this was 2005. I started rapping when I was 15. It was literally the weekend I was turning 16 is when I moved back to Arizona, right? And I lived in Green Valley. So I went to Sahuarita High School.
Nice.
So the first dude that I met in the area, he was a rapper. You know, said he was a rapper. He was a little bit older than me. You know, said he was a rapper. So conditionally, I started to turn what was like poems and shit throughout school into rap because I was listening. I was hanging out with this dude, and he was from Seaside, California.
Okay.
And so all he listened to was, you know, hyphy music at the time.
Yeah.
You know, it was definitely a lot of Mac Dre, Yug Mouth, the Loonies. You know. All that kind of stuff.
E-40 and them.
Absolutely. And E-40 was the reason that I got Giddy Gouda.
Okay.
Because the record on My Ghetto Report Card.
Okay.
I played that every day. Every single minute.
What was a big single off that CD?
Tell Me When to Go.
Dumb, dumb. That video was like transcendent for me.
Dog.
That was Ghetto Report Card, you said?
That was my Ghetto Report
Card. That's right. Okay.
And that You and then, that Booty.
Muscle Cars. I think Muscle Cars was
you
on that.
You and that Booty. Was that on that same CD?
I don't think so. I think that was newer.
Okay.
Wasn't that T-Pain's
I believe
song?
So. Wow, yeah. My car going to get pulled if I'm wrong. But
no, that's
yeah,
all good.
No. So he had a song on that album called Gouda.
Gouda.
And I was like, I want to go by Gouda. I was like, I got to put something in front of it, though. So it was literally like 3 seconds. I was like, giddy Gouda. That's it. Like, that's literally how it came up. You know what I'm saying? That's what it is. Nice. You know? And I went by that until about 2012.
What brought on the name change, the rebranding?
I quit, just like most people. You know, okay. I was in college. I was playing basketball. I was playing college ball for a junior college. And
where'd you play at?
I played at Imperial Valley College.
Okay.
In El Centro, California. Right. On the border of Mexicali, Brawley, Heber, Hemet.
Okay.
All that kind of area.
Okay, yeah.
So I was out there, man. I was the Arabs. Yeah! Damn! The Imperial Valley Arabs. That was our mascot.
Fucking crazy.
Have they changed it since?
No, it's still the same.
Fuck you.
Still the same. Yeah. I mean, it was like the school was so small. Because if you go to these California JUCOs, they're huge, bro. They're huge. They look like damn near D2 universities.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Not this one. This one was not the same. Like, we didn't have a football team. We didn't have a track team. It was literally just men's basketball, women's volleyball, and men's soccer.
Okay.
That's all we had. That's it. You know, it was like a low-grade high school, you know. But, you know, at the time when I was playing, it was the only school that had offered me a spot on the team.
Okay.
So I took it. I took it right away. You know what I'm saying? So,
nice. You did that for how long did you do that for?
So I was out there just 2 years.
Just 2 years?
You know, I was there from 2010 to 2012. So I stayed there for an extra year because I didn't get any offers, you know, after that. And then I tried out for a school in Riverside called La Sierra University. Made the team. Right before school started, the coach quit. Everybody lost their scholarships.
Damn, really?
You know what I'm saying? So
that sucks.
That happened with that. So I never played at the university level, you know, besides summer league and practice, you know. But, yeah, so I quit during that time. And because I was like, I'm not getting no traction. You know, nothing's happening. And the biggest thing was I was working with the alumni. But it wasn't the label itself. It was an artist by the name of Sean Brown.
Okay.
So if you're familiar with the alumni, it's Kid Ink.
Right.
That's the label that he's on with DJ Hill Will. So it was Devin Cruz as well, and Sean Brown was one of the artists. I was working with Sean. Something happened where he took a Facebook post indirectly, you know, and right after that, he blocked my number, blocked all social media. I couldn't get in contact with him to even explain the situation. And I was so close because we was doing opening shows for Kid Ink when he first signed the RCA,
yeah.
You know, and shit like that. Anything in California, we were open. And I never thought I would get that close. You know what I'm saying? So after that, so I was like, I'm fucking done. A year passed. I got back into it. A homie that was drunk at a bar, like, recited, like, a whole song of mine, like, word for word, back to me when I was just at a club. And I was like, I'm going to pick it back up. Changed my name. My middle name is Thomas. Last name is Williams. Tommy Will. My father's name is Tommy Williams.
Okay.
Tommy Will.
That's
where it comes from. I was like, I don't want to do nothing that's not fake. Everything has to be me now if I'm going to do this again. So long story short, that's where it came from, man.
That's dope, man. That's dope, dog. You knocked out like three of my questions right.
My bad,
boom,
man.
Boom. No, that's beautiful, man. Let's dog, like, it's awesome when you have somebody who just feels, who can tell their story. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes it takes people, like, you got to, like, really ask them shit to get stuff out of them, dog. But, like, I feel like, you know, when all I got to do is really just ask you something and you can explain it and you can let us know. And literally, like I said,
you're a very good guest. That's what he's trying to say.
Long story short, that's what I'm kind
of
saying.
Like, when you get to, like, this point of the music career and you're, like, not even still independent, because independent just became a positive term probably, you know, very recently.
Right.
You know, nobody cared about independence, you know, 5, 6, 7 years ago, really. Yeah. Not the sense that it is now.
I don't know. I feel like that's a different take, though. Like, You thought that was derogatory?
It was derogatory because it means you didn't make it.
I felt like local ass something, whatever.
Like a lab
extension,
like the Kevin Hart.
Your local ass bitch. Yeah, yeah, I think that's hella fucking offensive.
So let me tell you this. So the only independent artist I would say a couple years ago, I'm gonna take it about 6-7 years ago because that's to where I can't think of right now. Tech N9ne.
Right. When I think of underground artists that have like took it from underground to like something bigger, right. Tech N9ne is the first name that usually comes to my mind.
Because at the time there was no social media. There was no, I mean, Facebook is not a musician's platform. You can make an entertainer's page that tells you you're an artist or a business, whatever you are.
Right.
But it's not a music platform. So at the time, 6-7 years ago, it was hard copy CDs out your trunk. Nobody had music videos like that unless you had the plugs and the connections and you had the money.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? But now you can become a rapper and get your shit on iTunes, Apple, Spotify in a day. In a day. Mm-hmm. Even if you recorded it like on a headphone jack. In a day.
Yep.
And people will hear you and you can go viral depending on what you're doing.
Yeah.
You know,
maybe the next fucking Old Town Road.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, yeah. I mean, and there's a lot of shit going about that because the producer, Young Kia, you know what I'm saying? He's been going through a lot of stuff because they're saying he hasn't cleared his samples, you know, and things of that nature. But it's like the kid, I don't know how old he is, probably a young kid, you know, because he was selling his beats for like $30 or $20. That's how much he bought the beat for. It was like $30. You know what I'm saying? And it went absolutely nuts. And that's how quick it can go. You know what I'm saying? And that's why I stress. Like, I sat on so much music for so long and just never put it out because I never thought it was perfect. And it'll never be perfect. It won't.
I think that's the biggest problem I have with producing right now. I can never finish a project. I always rework it.
It'll never be perfect, bro.
Well, that's why I'm trying to get to the point where I can finish a track. And
it's
move
done.
On.
Most of the time, it's probably
on.
Done.
And but I've had been producing music on and off for the past 10 years.
I feel
that. But I've never put anything finished product. There's no raw stem.
Oh, you have never.
I'll
done
always
it.
Scrap it after a couple.
Oh,
after
what the
a
fuck
week.
Are you waiting for? Right?
Yeah,
dog.
After
fuck
a week,
that.
I'll scrap it and I'll just be like, "Fuck it, I'll come up with
fuck
something
that."
The fuck is you doing?
So now it's time to really like. Now I have cash to buy equipment, at. Dog.
Yeah,
I can buy Roland sequencers. I can, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's the difference I didn't have back then 10 years ago is I couldn't afford that equipment. Now, I can literally go into the store and buy any fucking equipment piece that I want.
Yeah, man.
So,
man.
I mean.
It's a blessing.
For sure. But, I mean, there's other areas that will hurt if I splurge and buy something huge like that. You know what I'm saying? Right. Not going to go eat out all the fucking time and shit like that. But I'm just trying to be more fucking productive with that creation of something like. Hearing the inspiration, it's inspirational hearing how, like, you're on the cusp of greatness and then you gave it up and then you're coming back and you're hitting it full force again, you know?
There's no other choice. There's no other choice. When you think of something so bad, bro, that makes you cry at night, dog, I'm telling you, this shit will eat you alive, bro.
Dude.
This shit will eat you alive.
Fuck yeah. But, dog, you know what, dog, man? And if you really listen to the podcast, man, like, we've had these conversations with other artists and other people as far as when we're talking about the scene, and your name is always brought up, bro. Your name is always brought up, bro. I feel like I feel it, bro. Like, I feel it in my bones, dog, that like your time is definitely coming, man. You know what I'm saying?
It's appreciated.
I fucking
greatly,
I believe in you, bro, for reals. And I know like you have everything there to fucking really make it happen, bro. I know you do. I just know your opportunity's fucking coming, man. So just please continue to do what you're fucking doing, man. For real.
Thank
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, it's not gonna stop me. And I tell people, because it's a large number, man. When you tell a kid that's only 18 or 19 that you've been rapping for 14 years.
Yeah, man.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like, how do they look at you? But at the same time, like, there's a record I'm working on for my album, man. It's called Growing Pains. And it's literally about being, you know, an artist. I just touched my 30s. You know what I'm saying? I just turned 30 in July.
How you feel about that?
You know what I'm saying? It's the same.
I'm 34. I just turned 34 this year.
Oh, man.
I just turned
happy belated, bro.
Thank you.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
Are you fucking serious?
Yeah, dog. It's funny. That's the same shit that Shono said when I told him. And this was barely like maybe 6-8 months ago when he was down here. And we were driving and shit. And he was looking at me and it was like, what did you just say? I was like, bro, I just fucking turned. And he was like, fucking lying to me right now. Dog. And I was like, nah, man. And then he just starts fucking smiling and shit. He's like, good for you, dude. I was like, thank you. Damn.
But if that doesn't give you like, more initiative to push harder, like, I don't know what else does, because my goal was always to get a residency downtown Tucson. And we talked a little bit about that.
Yeah.
And I am on the cusp of doing that.
Absolutely.
So my ultimate goal was getting a residency in Vegas.
Okay. Yeah.
That's making
it. There's nothing that can hold you back from that.
No, for sure. But it's taken me so long to rebuild because I had a child. Yeah. So after I had that kid, I walked away from DJing. I didn't DJ for like 2 years straight, bro.
I feel that. That's a life-changing moment.
Yeah, man. And now I'm back at it full force. Like,
so I'll tell you, like, the thing that kind of flipped me around was music is turning into something to where your age doesn't matter. That's a thing inside of your head.
Right.
And it's any aspect of music, whether it's this podcasting or whether it's being a rapper or a singer or, you know, that shit, it doesn't matter anymore. It doesn't. And like, if you ever, like, there's another meme. I love Twitter now. I never post, but I love like scrolling on Twitter. Mm-hmm. So there was one that posted like the ages of like Jay-Z and Kanye and J. Cole and like Kendrick Lamar and like stuff like that. And they're all like, they're past their 30s. You know what I'm saying? Some of them past their 40s. Mm-hmm. And these guys are legends, you know, right. Absolute legends. And you look back to like the first time that you heard them, I'm saying that the age doesn't matter if you're thinking that high. And that's where I'm thinking. I'm right. Not thinking like I want to make one record that pops and then I tour that same song for 5 years. Like, no, I want to make something like life-changing, like something significantly different to where I can make a residual income from music to put back into the city.
Yeah, man.
You know what I mean? Like, I want, you know, free recording studios, you know, basketball courts that are, you know, 24/7 indoor gym, kids off the street type shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you really look at Tucson, you got people like Terrell Stoglin, Bryce Cotton, Anthony Michaels, Calvin Jarvis, you know, and so many more. There's another chick. I wasn't in Arizona at the time. I was still in California that was on. It was either American Idol or it was The Voice. Do you know who I'm talking about?
Yeah, Jordan Sparks.
Jordan Sparks as well, but there was another chick. I think Jordan Sparks is from Phoenix, right?
Yeah.
Well, who's the one that was from Tucson?
I think she
used to rock with Buddha.
Yeah, she did rock with Buddha, man. I can't remember her fucking name right off top right now.
Yeah, I'll insert it
right here.
Yeah, we'll do that. So, but like her, there's all these people that, you know, and they push the culture. So when you really sit back and think about like Tucson lifestyle, like it's there, but there just has to be something to uproot that.
Right.
You know, and that's what I turned into as far as a musician. You know, it's not about just putting out songs and being a rapper. It's like, well, now what can I do to really change the lives of people in the city?
Yeah.
You know, we're not talking Instagram posts. We're talking billboards.
Well, dude, that's,
you know what I'm saying?
You beautifully led me into my next fucking question, which is I usually always ask that question of, do you feel like you need to move to like L.A. or something like that to further your career? Or do you feel like you can do it directly from here?
You can do it from Tucson.
You can do it from Tucson.
But you have to be willing to travel.
Right.
That's the difference.
Right.
Like, big shout out to the Music Entrepreneur Club. So it's a club online on Facebook. I don't know if you're familiar. It's between the three founders, I would say. Damian Ritter, Kato on the track, and DJ Payne One.
Okay.
So these are three guys who have become, I can't say good friends, but I really look up to these guys.
Okay.
I thoroughly look up to these guys. You know, DJ Payne One, he's an acclaimed producer. Kato... Definitely. I mean, he's a dude that I worked with on Vomit.
Right.
He was a member of Funk Volume with Dizzy Wright, Hobson, Swizz, Jaron Benton.
Okay.
You know, these guys.
Right, right.
He was one of the producers. DJ Hoppa as well was on there. And Damian Ritter, who was the CEO of Funk Volume, or co-CEO.
Okay.
I would say. So these guys lead this. It's a Facebook page and a membership quality item.
Mm-hmm.
And just you know, looking into things like that, man. And it just, once you learn about the business and all that shit, like, music turns in from a hobby into like a, like this entity. You just want to reach it. You just want to get there. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And once I learned the business part of it, it was like, it's over with. Like, this is way too fun. You know what I'm saying? Way too fun.
So, okay. Well, that's, I mean, yeah, dude, I think that that's been the consensus of the people that will say, like, I'd rather be there to be able to be in that kind of a scene all the time.
And then I went way off track and I just realized that.
No. It's all good. No, because no, you did answer that because you said you would make you can. You said that you so could you do can it make from it here.
Yeah,
but like you said, you got to be willing to travel, and that is the biggest thing. And even Buddha said that too, because he was like, bro, he's like, if I continue to live my life thinking that I have to be somewhere else to make it, I'm never gonna make it here
100%.
With that kind of mentality. 100%. So he's, you know, he when he said that, I was like blown away by that, because I mean, it's true. You know, you got to be, you can do it from where you're at, but you do have to be able to go to these places and, you know, either tour or get, you know, recognized in these different things, try to get on these different concerts or, you know, festivals and shit like that, get 100%. Your name, your brand out there and shit like that, you know, can't
you know really do it
just from here. Who?
DJ Yours Truly.
Okay. Yeah. He was the
motherfucker is on the road.
Yeah.
Like 5 times out the week, bro.
No shit.
Like 5 times out the week.
That's
motherfucker
dope,
drives everywhere. I don't get it. But yeah, no, I think the point that I was trying to bring, because I never said it, was I met Dame because I drove through the night from Tucson to LA. I think it took me like 7 hours. I got to LA at 4 in the morning, slept in a hammock until 6 in the morning for 2 hours. Just to play basketball with him.
With who?
With Damian Ritter.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Just to play basketball with him. You know what I'm saying? Just because I wanted to be in that presence. You know what I'm saying? I told him, I hit him up. I was like, bro, when is it? Because it was a mutual thing. It's not all about music all the time. It's mutual appreciations. He plays basketball. I play basketball. Cool, bro. Hey, when's the next time you playing basketball? We do open gym at LA Fitness at 6 in the morning. I'm there. You know what I'm saying? Drove up, we had a little like a little lunch, talked like 45 minutes, and I drove back to Tucson.
Fuck yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Work
shit
it.
Like that. And it was like, and that's somebody that I truly, truly respect. You know what I'm saying? And if you want to work with someone, you have to truly, truly respect them, no matter what level. If I want a graphic from you, or if I want to be on the Hood Diner podcast, I have to truly, truly respect what you're doing to be able to be a part of that. You know what I'm saying? Or definitely. They wouldn't make the move. You know,
right?
It's true, tell man. You can tell who's really about it.
It's true, man.
In the end.
It's definitely true, man. So, so you think what? So as far as music goes, what would you think? What would you say has been the biggest obstacle for you?
It's the most fucked up one. It's finances.
Finances.
You know, but the second one that I will put straight into that is time. You know, you can only do so much. And when you're at, you know, when you're at a level, you have to, there's a lot of waiting, you know, there's a lot of patience, you know, with music. Like I could put out a song today. Like I can make a song and I'm like, I want to put this out right now. I don't want to waste any time, but these songs aren't getting uploaded to these, you know, streaming companies immediately.
Right.
You know, it's not SoundCloud anymore. You know what I'm saying? So I could put my music up through my distribution, it's
takes
still
like
going to take
like
7
weeks,
days
right?
to Spotify.
Week, yeah.
Still going to take 2 weeks for Tidal, you know, a week and a half for Apple Music. So no matter what, if I think this is the one that's going to pop, and I put it out that second, time is taken away from me.
You got still got a week that you got to
you
wait.
Know what I mean?
Yeah,
that I got to wait for it's like, man,
so
I
got to
like done.
So you got to like plan it out, right? Like
you,
you got to be like strategic as far as like when you upload to the release date that it comes
absolutely.
Out and shit. Yeah, man.
And that's the thing about it not being perfect, because, you know, it's never ready, you know, so why I gotta wait another 7 days just to second guess myself?
Yeah.
You know, it's kind of fucked up. But
I feel
yeah,
that 110%.
You have to strategize. Have
like
to strategize.
Reworking the same fucking track over and over again. That's how, like I said, that's
it
where I'm at.
It gets bad, bro. Like after like the 5th or 6th day, it gets bad.
You start changing your bass line. You start changing your rhythm. You completely do a different melody. You do a different bass line. You do different drums. Like, that's me talking about. So,
you gotta get those ads working. Use those ads.
I'm gonna get a couple plugins, bro, and, like, I think after that, I'm gonna be pretty set. Like, get a MIDI keyboard, you know, just to knock out different chords, and I draw all of it in.
I feel that.
But just to actually hear what the chord progression sounds like and melodies and shit, I'm gonna have that, and then I wanna have the beat pad, and yeah, like I said, I want to start producing more. I want to do an intro eventually, you know, for the podcast.
Let's do it, man. What's next, man?
So I've noticed that you've been doing different shit besides rapping, obviously. I had no idea you were DJing until you guys talked about it a little bit earlier. That's dope. Yeah. When did you start doing that?
I started doing that. I was forced to.
Okay.
I was forced to because me and the homie Marley B, of course, we left on tour. We had our own tour with the little homie Red, and we didn't have a DJ, you know. So I went to Best Buy, applied for a Best Buy credit card. I got a very fucked up deal on one, but I got it anyway. And now I'm paying $700 for a $150 DJ controller.
Oh,
you know what I'm saying? But you can't put money on the experience.
This is true.
So I'm not even mad at it. But we didn't have a DJ, so I bought it. I bought a DJ controller, bought a wireless mic. Or no, I was gifted a wireless mic.
Nice.
Yeah, we went on tour, man. So I had to learn how to do it from there, and I didn't want to be no shitty DJ, you know? So YouTube tutorials, you know, anything I could do to try to learn it.
Right.
You know, I spent like the whole week. I think I had like 6 days before we left is when I had it. So just hooked all my recording equipment up to that, and I practiced, man.
Fuck yeah.
Then it turned into something to where I was like, you know, I could do this, you know, to a certain extent.
Right.
You know, it's another level of, another lane of creativity.
Yeah. So, not just that, it's another, you know, it could be another
it could
income
be a financial
or revenue
income.
Stream, you know what I'm saying?
No, it could be, absolutely.
When I was doing the whole event center, dog, for the 3 years that I did it, like, I always wanted to DJ, dog. I even wound up buying myself a controller, too. I got myself, like, a little fucking...
You got a Newmark?
Newmark, there you go. Yeah, Newmark one, the little thing goes around and shit like that, and it's got the beats per minute right there.
It's funny because my Newmark CD players are sitting right there.
That's fire.
That's what I used to do Serato on.
You used to do it?
Yeah, I got turntables now.
Okay, so I can have that.
I mean... So you have a controller right now, right?
Yeah.
But we're not talking about that. But you would need a mixer though for you to be able
to
use
those. You're escaping the question.
No, I'm not saying that. I want to be honest with you. They need to be serviced for one. But two, I wouldn't even be opposed to giving them to you, bro.
You're a legend.
But the point of me bringing that is you still need a mixer to cut from track.
Hey, they sell mixes at pawn shop, bro.
For sure.
Right.
Always over there.
Bro, we know the homie Deliquid.
The first high-end mixer I got was the one I'm using now.
Okay.
I bought a used Rain 50. No, it's not the newest one with the touchscreen. It has the smaller buttons. It's the one that Rip uses. It's that Rain. Well, I bought that one. It just wasn't as buttery. I spent a good amount of money on there.
Buttery.
Like the fader.
That's a DJ word.
Buttery. Yeah.
Right there. Buttery. When you cut, buttery. When you cut on the fader, yeah. You know, to be like literally like
it's gotta be buttery.
0.01 of a millimeter from open to close. You know, so you can do the tricks and shit. Like
I'm gonna insert that. I'm putting that porn music right there.
I didn't like it. Well, I ended up having to spend another like $500 to get the Pioneer S9 that I use now. It's the one with the beat pads and shit on there. But that's like my first high-end mixer, and it's like you definitely pay for what you get. You know what I'm saying? Like that mixer, I'm so good with that mixer, I don't even have to take CD players. I can run it all internal.
That's wild.
Yeah. And but I've been playing Serato for fucking over 10 years, bro. So the one thing I can say is this, practice your transitions more than anything.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
That's the most important thing. That's even more important than the songs that you're playing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I heard DJ fuck some transitions up last week. I was like, ooh, that was bad. And I think I said it a little too loud.
He heard you, he's all.
I don't think he heard
it. Hey, man, it happens.
I think like somebody that worked in the building. That
shit happens.
I think it was like a waitress that heard me and shit. I was like, ooh, that was a bad transition. Like, she could have gone back and told her to do that. Some guys out there complain about your transitions.
That's a possibility.
Step your game up, player.
Right. Okay. And then also, dog, you've been doing a little bit of photography lately, too.
That's where I'm at right now.
Nice. Okay. What made you want to get into doing that?
So I always had a camera. I bought one when I was in college, and I never used it.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So I had it because I was recording, like, game film, you know, practice film, right, stuff like that. But mm-hmm. I didn't know how to use it. So I always had one. I had a Nikon
D3100. Mm-hmm. I had the 5500 series.
There you go. All right. That's a one-upper right there.
One-upper.
I had to have that little that screen that moved because I'm a big dude. I can't get down that low.
Come on, man.
So I had to be able to lift that screen down and
use
my
arms. All that means is you had more money than me at the time. No, hey, well, man.
Humble brag.
This dude.
Solid flex right there.
No.
No flex on cash.
So, yeah, no, I had that. And then it really wasn't until, like, I want to say, like, maybe, like, 4 months ago. You know, where I was like, I looked at the camera and I was like, I'm going to use you, man. I was like, I need to be creative in other aspects.
Right.
You know, to help out with the music. That was the hope for it.
It helps. And then not to mention, you can market yourself and shit. True. All you really got to do is, you know, I mean, well, it's kind of hard to take pictures of yourself, but it's not. It is, but it's not.
It just takes a minute to set it up,
get the fucking the focus just right and shit to where you're standing, and then set the timer or use like a remote and shit. Dude, I've had to do it a couple times for some shit.
It sucks.
But
right
I feel
now,
you, man. Yeah.
I'm not going to lie. As far as trying to, you know, do that for myself. But so I, you know, doing research, I found out like the camera's a good part of it, but the lenses
are what really fucking changes shit. Yeah.
So I went and I bought a 50mm for my Nikon.
Okay.
And after that, I was like, okay, I'm getting the nifty 50, learn angles, you know, and getting the bokeh right and all that.
That's
shit.
That's what it is, baby.
You know what I'm saying? So I kept going to pawn shops. I was like,
You can come up at pawn shops.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
Oh, shattered dreams are real.
Man.
Bruh.
So the homie Sonny.
It's real sure.
Sonny and Shayna. They said, oh, you going to shoot? Get a Canon. They got Sonys. I'm like, why not get a Sony? They was like, get a Canon.
Yeah.
So I was looking at pawn shops for a Canon. I found one. Canon 60D. Came with a backpack, two batteries, rubber grip, whole bunch of shit for like $125.
What?
Ooh, okay. You know what I'm saying?
Picked that up easy, bought a 25mm. I just picked up a 75 to 300. You know what I'm saying? Like,
and that 75 to 300 is gonna come in clutch at weddings and shit. When you can't be right up in the mix of shit,
bro,
dude.
Don't hold that shit without a tripod, though.
Yeah,
don't hold it without a tripod.
Definitely. Yeah.
I couldn't do it. I'm not that in there yet. Just the lens is so light compared to the camera. I'm like trying to lean up against the wall and shit.
You gotta
trying to
do
get
that.
A solidified
I always
shot
think of that Woody Harrelson deep, shit where you gotta like,
yeah, just like that, like click. A sniper rifle.
Oh, straight you gotta be up. Still.
Yeah,
like you gotta when, be super
when,
you, still.
When you're doing shit like because I learned I learned it quick.
Fire,
bro. It's like
I learned it quick, bro, because I'm telling you, I would go to the fucking rap shows and shit, and I was taking pictures. Thankfully, I had like my 35mm with a fucking lower aperture, so you could get low light shit like nicely, and it makes the colors look nice
like,
and
bro.
Shit,
I
right?
Like that low light shit.
But sometimes there's a situation where I couldn't get right up front, so I had to use my fucking shit from the back. Like I have like an 18-105 and shit that I would use. But that shit, dog, yeah, like if you even any little movement, you're going to have those fucking like light fucking movements and shit. And sometimes it looks cool. But like, yeah, it's almost like really shooting, like shooting. You got to like inhale, exhale smoothly. And then I fucking click right at the end of that exhale right there, dog. You know what I'm saying? That's Woody Harrelson on fucking Zombieland.
Straight up.
Right there, buddy. Like shout out to Woody right there, buddy. But yeah, man. But it's fun though, right? It's fun. Bro, I love taking photos, bro.
And I have an addictive personality, bro. Like straight up. That's what really, you know, put me on with the rap shit.
And you said you did a fucking wedding, right? You just said
I did a wedding. Shout out to the homie Ago, man. Congratulations, bro. I love you, dog. Thank you for having me on such a special occasion, man.
That's
dope. He invited me out to do his wedding.
Were you nervous?
Photography. I was palm sweating, mom spaghetti.
Mom spaghetti?
All that shit, bro. Telling you. I even told him I was that. Like I told you earlier, bro. I told him, bro, I ain't been shooting that long. You probably don't want to book me. He's like, bro, he's like, I got faith in you, bro. And I had to look back. I was like, man, that's that Have Will shit, bro. That's
Will
shit.
Babe.
You know what I'm saying? So I was like, bro, I'll do my best. Pulled up. I shot for 3.5 hours, bro. I never had more fun. You know what I'm saying?
Man.
It was amazing.
Fuck yeah, man. Well, I got one more question before the island question, dog. If you could collaborate with any artist dead or alive, what would it be?
I was thinking about this. It was tough. It was absolutely fucking tough. I would not name it because I can't think of one specifically. But if I had to, it would be Big Sean.
Big Sean?
I do it.
Big Sean is my absolute favorite artist of all time.
Yeah.
From the way that he conducts his music, his fashion line, just the way that he is as a person. Like, that dude is like my fucking idol, bro.
No shit.
Like, Big Sean.
You know what's crazy is I've never really obviously off my own fault, but I've never looked into Big Sean enough.
Man.
I know I've heard songs with him, obviously, but I haven't gone like back catalog, like all his shit, dude. I'm going to have to check him out, dog.
My favorite mixtapes or projects from him is the mixtape Detroit.
The Detroit, yeah.
That shit goes hard.
Absolutely. No, it was, man. The Finally Famous mixtape.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Of course.
You got to look back into those, man. Like, and it was ever since.
But I felt like Detroit, he just hit a stride. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, no. 100%. And the thing that I really liked about him was, like, the album was like albums the way I probably would have tried to do one. You know, he had a lot of really playable stuff.
Yeah.
That I feel like he just put out because he felt like he had to. And then there was always one that I knew was his. Like, One Man Could Change the World.
Was Marvin Gaye and Chardonnay after Detroit?
Before.
No, it was before?
Yeah.
Okay. I felt like right that period, he was coming out of Protégé status.
Like that Ye, that Kanye, Protégé?
He was coming out of like Protégé status, and he was becoming his own artist at that particular time in his career. Like, he was the main draw at that point. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I mean, that was a huge hit for him. He probably saw a big chunk of money.
That was a big push. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Fuck yeah, man.
I would say that, though.
Big Sean?
Big Sean.
Okay, dog. So we have arrived at the island question. The island question is, you are all alone on an island, and you can only take one book, one album, one movie, and one food with you for the rest of your life, or as long as you're alive on the island. What would they be?
One book, one album, one movie.
One book, one album, one movie, and one food.
And one food. Mm-hmm. The food would be peanut butter and jelly.
Like, yeah,
that's 100%. Butter, jelly,
peanut
time.
Butter, jelly,
that's
time.
That's what it is.
Fuck yeah. I fuck with peanut butter jelly.
The movie would probably be Coach Carter.
Okay.
Coach Carter.
What's the one that G-Baby died in?
You talking about Fastball?
Yeah.
Or Hardball?
Yeah, that's my shit right there.
Hardball.
You went so
that's
left
wild,
right
bro.
There.
You just went to a whole different
so
sport.
Left.
Sorry.
That's fucked up, man.
High thinking.
Don't be off, man.
That's high thinking. I'm saying.
Man, throw me all the way off.
Coach Carter,
okay.
He said.
One.
You know, my favorite basketball movie is Above the Rim, but not a second close one would be Sunset Park.
Sunset Park was cool.
That was my shit.
That was fire.
Mine's White Man Can't Jump.
Okay.
White Man Can't Jump.
Fucking love
of course, it's a classic.
Rosie Perez.
Billy, you're so stupid, Billy.
I love it.
I don't know. I just think Coach Carter's the epitome of basketball.
Fuck yeah.
Movies at the moment.
One album.
One album. I'd probably say Get Rich or Die Trying.
Bro, that's
not
a,
even
that's
probably.
A, okay, and
I would definitely
and,
say.
And just to be it. Clear, we're thinking of 50's first album and not the movie soundtrack, right?
Absolutely.
Okay, just making sure I have to ask that question.
That was your best friend. Because we everybody, there's no other. Who else said that? It was recent.
It was fucking who was just here?
Nasty Black.
Yeah. He said that right there too. Yeah, and then a couple people before him too. I want to see somebody else said that.
That's
shit.
A very popular
I
album.
Might have been, I think Nene might have said the same shit.
Yeah,
I think Marley said it too.
I think did Marley say it? Yeah, I think he did. I think
he might have said it too. That's yeah, funny. No, that was a. I mean, during that
fuck
time,
that album
I mean,
was
probably
fucking.
We're all around the same age as those people that.
That was 03. That's the year I graduated.
You know what I'm saying? I was a freshman.
Okay,
I'm sorry for your age.
Hey, dog.
I was doing my thing.
I'm just playing, man.
Y'all
like
had
I said,
fucking.
AJ ain't shit.
Y'all were like, y'all, jerk. You're a jerk.
Oh, yeah.
Jerk,
new boys.
Jerk.
I
that was your guys' like, time.
Hey,
and
man,
I'm just
come
like.
Come on, we was in there. I didn't.
03,
I
was
jerk,
doing auto
man.
Glass. I was doing auto glass.
I wasn't
geeked
a new
up
boy.
On shit, dog.
I wasn't
auto glass. Okay. So you said, okay.
I probably don't have a book, to be honest.
You know how to read? I don't
I'm not a. I try to do so much. It's fucked up and I should. I know that, but. I mean, in all honesty, bro,
You know
I don't
what? Maybe we'll just give you a fucking just a blank book so you can write rhymes and shit.
You could. I mean, I'm doing the book. I'm actually
you can't have a phone. There's no phone there. This is a desert island. There's no phone.
No reception.
Whatever plays the music. We should make those boundaries on. We should be like, and the album is like a fucking, you know, like an old school CD, like a Discman.
Do you have a solar panel?
So no, there's no MP3 at all, motherfucker. You got something on
your Zoom, bro?
No Zoom. No Zoom.
No
Zoom.
No, I brought that shit up.
I never copped no Zooms.
I fucking had a Zoom.
I had a Zoom.
I had the Zoom.
I had an early ass iPod. My nephew still has my Zoom. Early. The screen wasn't even colored.
Dog, I had this shit. It was like this little black box, but the CDs that you would buy were like on squares.
Yeah, mini disc.
Yeah, the Sony mini disc. I had that.
Yeah, I had that shit.
I still have it. Bro. It's at the house right now.
How the fuck am I supposed to give out an album on that shit, bro?
Hey, like, that's what it is, man.
That's crazy. That's
Sony mini disc.
That's a transition.
That's what you get what to take it on.
What if the disc war would have won and no one would have did like flash drives and micro nanotechnology?
I would be so popping.
Crazy,
I would be so popping. You know a lot how of many CDs people press? Would be tired of like doing that old CD press shit? Remember where you had to get like the sticker and it had like the little machine and you just kind of like push it down? You
know I had that. And then it would get stuck in certain people's things. When it would got warm, when you played it too much, and then fucking one day it would just stop fucking moving and shit. And you look in there and there's like little pieces of fucking sticker all over the place and shit. Like if you do get it ejected, it comes off with like some of the pieces missing and shit. Oh man, I remember that shit.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, but I take it back to Discman's, man. I remember rolling in my Sentra with the fucking tape deck, but I had the tape thing plugged into the Discman, and the Discman, I had it like on a bunched up towel so that it was like kind of working as a little bit of fucking shock stabilization, resistance. Stock stabilization, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like that. You had to have a nice fluffy towel right there on the car, because if not, it was just blah, 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 blah. Like you see it in the movies, like on fucking Wayne's World, they have it on the dash and shit. Nah, son, that fucking shit would probably be skipping all the fucking time, bro.
Especially I mean, Tucson
unless you had like awesome ass, like a fucking Range Rover or a Lexus, where it's like just a smooth ass ride.
Right.
But then by that time, you would have had the Discman in your fucking CD player. You know what I mean? So, but yeah, man. So okay, so like okay, one book, you know, take like a blank book, write your own story.
We do that.
You know what I'm saying? With it. And then you said, what album was it again?
Get Rich or Die Trying.
Get Rich or Die Trying.
Absolutely.
The movie.
Coach Carter.
Coach Carter, and then the food, peanut butter jelly
sandwiches.
Peanut butter jelly time. Fuck yeah, man. Before we wrap it up, we want to go ahead and let everybody know where they can follow you at. Where can everybody follow you online, bro?
So everywhere is at HaveWill, H-X-V-E, Will. I put the X because it's trendy.
Okay.
And that's the only,
and that's the only one that's not trendy. Spelled right in there, right?
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Everything else is the same. Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, all that stuff is the same. Or you can look up Tommy Will. You know what I'm saying? Like, we're just trying to do a lot of cool shit, man.
Oh yeah.
Like, at the end of the day.
So you've been dropping a shitload of singles lately and shit, man. Some dope ass fucking singles.
I got a lot, man.
Do you have an album or anything coming up pretty soon?
I have a few.
I really dig the Sunflower track.
Sunflower Sundays?
Yeah.
Sunflower,
that was
super
dope.
Fire, man.
I did the album cover on that one. Hey.
Yes, you did. Shout out to you.
Self little fucking plug right now.
You know what I'm saying?
We're not about sucking our own dicks over here.
Super fire. Hey, I loved it when you first sent it to me.
It happens.
You know, other people had opinions at the time.
Right? It's all good though, man.
You know what I'm saying?
We made it happen.
Yeah. No, man. Like, I got a bunch of singles. I have I have an album stashed. It's not, I released it earlier. At least the information. With DJ Payne 1.
Okay.
We have an album called Willionaire.
Okay.
That's just,
I like that.
You know what I'm saying? So that's a,
you need a fucking old No Limit Cash Money.
You keep Cash Money. Don't be doing that
Willionaire
shit.
You need one of that for that single.
That'll be fire, man.
It's possible, but I can already see something else a little more classy.
You know what I'm saying? You might have to bless me with that, bro.
Hey, you never know.
So I have that project.
I'm on it, baby. I'll take care of you. You can find me at Casual520 all across the board.
DJ _Century everywhere.
And collectively, you can find us at thehooddinerpodcast.com. Actually, no, I'm sorry. Let me rephrase that. You can find us collectively at thehooddiner.com, and there you can get all the socials from that direct spot. We need to talk about that, because we need to set that up, because I already started building it. Okay. Like, it's almost looking like the way it used to look, like with the brick wall and shit, but it looks a lot more cleaner now. There's like more blue glow coming off the wall and fucking the little logos in the middle and shit, and then it's going to scroll down, goes to the pictures that Bert took of us and
that. Yeah.
Has a little bio. It's going to look fucking sick, dog. So
speaking of pictures, I might need you to come. What do you got going on Saturday?
I have a fucking funeral.
Fuck. Well, I'm going to have to hit somebody else up then.
What's up, man? We just talked about
it. He said he might come by. Yeah. He said he might come. Be like, hey, Tommy, bring your camera, bro.
Yeah, no shit. I got you, man. So this is the issue that's going on right now. Every single fucking flyer they use for me at Cobra
has the same fucking
I'm fucked up, bro. I fucking smoke a blunt before I go. The mixes are always fire, dog, but it's just...
Bro, I got it in my whip right now. All right.
Well, I mean, I ain't ready. I'm on. Yeah, you know.
No, I feel you.
You know.
Nah, man, I'm in there, bro.
All right, for sure. Gosh. And I got a bottle on deck, so we get faded.
For everybody who wants to know why I was laughing, he did that hole where he licks his index finger and his middle finger, and he like scrapes it across his fucking eyebrows, dude. Is that what it's called? Okay, I didn't know that it had a name.
What do you feel about his fucking necklace?
I didn't know that it had a name.
I think it's fucking fiery.
Yeah.
I wear my 99 cent bandanas like that. So the fact that he got one that cost probably like $500,000, I'm with it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Man. Like, it's a waste of money. But I want
bitches call
time,
me fucker.
Yeah.
That lyric
she call me Coast. Daddy, I don't even know her mama.
That dude's awful, bro.
Blueface.
It's
a new wave, bro.
I get it.
It's a new wave. You know what popped him off? Women, bro. Mm. Women love the dude. Women will support you. Like no one else, no matter what you're doing, bro. Mm.
Get a couple down chicks. Fuck,
shout out to my wifey. Yeah.
Like a friend, any of that shit, bro. You get you a chick that's really, really down, one of them, she will take you to a whole nother level, bro.
Amen.
A whole nother level.
Amen.
Women love Blueface.
Fuck yeah, man.
Before we go, I have to ask one question because of the documentary that just came out.
Yeah.
Travis Scott's overrated, underrated?
I've watched it 7 times.
No. Him as an artist. Underrated, overrated?
Oh, underrated.
Yeah?
Oh, my God.
That's the first time I've heard on here. Like, that's true. Everybody said
I haven't
overrated.
Watched that. Is it good?
100.
Is bro, the little thing good?
Absolutely amazing. Bro, I'm not playing. I've watched
Grammy
it
set him
times.
Up.
I thought you said you didn't fuck with Netflix.
Hey.
I watched that 7 times.
That smile. That was great.
I watched that 7 times. I'm not going to play it.
Like, I got you, man.
That shit from, like, everything that he took away from it, from just taking an aspect of his city, the Astro World concept, and wanting to create that for other people is something that I really dig into, because it's like there's differences from, like, bro, if I could go back in time, man, as many people think, it's like there was the Sharks nightclub, there was Deviate at the time, mm-hmm. It was Club Envy, it was not the District Tavern, it was Vaudeville was a
there,
big
I've
part. And it was the Battle League place.
Scrappies? Or
Scrappies,
about
the original Scrappies.
The original
that
Scrappies?
Was across from where Playground is now.
Right.
You know, that place. And I don't even know if that's the original, but during my time, that's
I think
where
it was.
Was,
yeah.
You know, so it's like, you know, places like that, it was like, dog, I was 17 trying to sneak in to rap, you know, stuff like that. Security had to get me in, get me out, you know, type shit like. Like, just remembering that hunger, like, and he turned Astro World, which a lot of the new generation doesn't know about, from Houston, into something that, you know, people are like, I got the feeling, because he throws the Astro World inaugurally, you know what I'm saying, annually, every year. So it's like, imagine, like, something from Tucson popping back up, like a Vaudeville, once a year. To give you that feeling, something that we had long ago that's not available now.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's absolutely amazing. He's underrated.
I like the sample they used from that documentary and that track with Uzi Vert. I'm going to Astro World for the last time or whatever she says.
Dog. Like, it's, and it wasn't, no, it was a little girl. It
right.
It was a baby
right,
girl in a
right,
news clip.
Right.
Yeah.
But and, I remember hearing that in the Uzi Vert song.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. No, I know what you're talking about. Yeah. So he fucking embodied that, man. Like, and that's all you can ask for.
I just like how he puts on for his city.
Yeah.
I feel like a lot of his tracks are overproduced. That's why I bring that up with a lot of...
He makes a lot of them himself.
Right.
As far as I know.
There's a lot going on in the track.
Oh, no, 100%. It's, I mean, you're under Kanye. Not under Kanye, but, I mean, you studied
with
Kanye.
You're under his tutelage, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You're one of those artists
sure.
that should be, like, the
under
next
the Kanye
in that,
tree. Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
So.
And he has the baddest chick in the game wearing his chain?
Like that. You know what I'm saying?
Like that's long money, bro. That me, you, and Kez don't know nothing about. You know what I'm saying?
But at the same time, the kid's young, man. He's just living his life. And he's living it well, bro.
Yeah,
he's
dog, positive. But your lady's younger than you. She's worth a billy.
Yeah, but he's not in jail. He's not doing no crazy crimes.
You understand? Like we go on vacation, dog. Like, it sets us back. Like, we come back to Tucson, we got to chill for a little bit type of shit. These motherfuckers just go on rolling vacations where it's like, oh, I'm touring tonight. Oh, I'm fucking...
Oh, you sound so salty, don't you?
No, no, that's not jealousy. That's not jealousy whatsoever. Like, God bless anybody doing well. I'm not no hater.
No, I feel what you mean, but like at the same time, that's why so many of these motherfuckers go crazy.
Right, substance abuse.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you got to dig into another world, bro. Like, can you imagine going out every night and always having your picture taken? I could barely get a motherfucker to take my picture right now if I pay them.
Right. I listened to the Steve Aoki podcast today with Joe Rogan. And he tours like 250 days a year.
It's a real thing.
So he's like, I can't party every fucking day. Like every time I tour, he goes, when
you'll
I started
6 months, bro.
When I started touring, yeah, I partied every day.
You'll die in 6 months.
But when you get to the point where it's 250 dates a year, there's no way you can be tearing down vodka the whole time.
No, absolutely not.
There's no way. He had vocal cord surgery, so he couldn't talk for a month. Coughs differently and sneezes differently than most people now. Crazy, huh?
It's crazy shit, man.
Well, like I said, bro, I really enjoy your new stuff coming out. Never really had a chance to kick it other than seeing you in passing at, like, shows and shit like that. But, like, thank you for coming on, bro. Like, this was a real fun time.
Bro, I'm a big fan. I'm a big fan of the Hood Diner, bro. Like, for sure. I listen every episode.
Okay.
Appreciate you, man.
I'm always tapped in on Spotify.
Oh yeah, man. And you know, this shit ain't gonna be the last time. Like I said, once I get, we talked before he even got here. We were talking about some of those ideas that I was telling you about outside. That I went, once those go down, you're gonna come back and bless them shits with us. Oh, okay,
man. I'm gonna be here, bro.
You know what I'm saying? Here, so yeah, man. Tommy Will, bro, we appreciate you coming in, dog. Episode 62. Fuck yeah, man. We covered some good shit.
It's been amazing, man.
Yeah, man. Until the next time.
I'm DJ Sentry.
I am the homie Casual. Peace.
Shit up ever,
yeah.
I ain't done no interview and no podcast.